the cult of personality. I know your anger, I know your dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. Like Mussolini and Kennedy, I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala on a Tuesday afternoon. We are live in the WOCA studios at the palatial studios of WOCA right here at the food court entrance to the Paddock Mall on a sunny Tuesday afternoon. I'm Tom Schmitz, here with you the whole show. Buddy Martin at SEC Media Days up in Hoover, Alabama. He'll be joining us later in the show. Also with me right now, I think he's got it up on Periscope, so if you want to go to Periscope and watch, Luke the intern is broadcasting on Periscope. Luke, what do they look for? What title you got going today?
I just titled it a simple one, First Hour of the Voice of Ocala.
So. First Hour of Voice of Ocala, so you can go find that on Periscope if you want.
Right.
You know, Periscope, a new thing that I'm learning about. I just learned about Mark Cuban's new what's it called? It's like Snapchat, but it's Mark Cuban's developed it. It's Dust something. I forget what it was, but I just, a lot of the sports guys and all are using that instead of Snapchat. I guess Cuban's kind of giving them like some sort of kickback. Who knows what Cuban's doing? I came across this story today. I always talk about how you don't see any movement in our county government, and our city government sometimes. And well, Florida Department of Environmental Protection, the DEP, has announced that it is committing $1,084,356 to remove septic tanks and install municipal sewer connections at Silver Spring State Park. They say this will eliminate the potential for the park's septic tanks to leach nutrient pollution, about 2,372 pounds of nitrogen annually into the groundwater. Consequently, that'll keep it out of the springs as well. Tom Frick, director of the Division of Environmental Assessment and Restoration, says the DEP is actively committed to protecting our natural resources. Removing these septic tanks protects water quality and advances our ongoing restoration effort for this system. They've had now this springs for 2 years. They're finally moving on the septic system there to hook up the municipal water. It's their ongoing quality and advances on our ongoing restoration effort for this system. When was the last time you were at Silver Springs, Luke?
It's been a couple years.
Right.
Yeah.
They've got the restoration going now, but it's the longest restoration I've ever seen in my life. Because I don't see a whole lot going on out there. Yeah, they drained the muck pond that was in front, you know, where all the algae was and everything as you walked into the park. But I don't see a whole lot of restoration going on. The buildings aren't getting rebuilt. Water's not getting cleaned. The non-native fish aren't being taken out. The non-native plants aren't being taken out and native plants being put back in. You know, let's do something. Scuba divers would come in right now and clean all the statues and all that are there. But how do I put this without aggravating anybody? What do I care about aggravating anybody? The tree huggers don't want them to do the right thing and make this economically viable. They want it to be this natural grown-up area where nature just does what it does and nobody can destroy it because it's the springs. Stop it. We have the largest artesian well, one of the largest, maybe the largest in the world. And we're just letting it sit there and bubble because we don't want to harm the ecosystem. How about taking advantage of the ecosystem and making a dollar off of it? How about that? How about that, mister? Oh, I got to protect the gopher turtles. Oh, I haven't bathed in 3 days. Stop it. How about you worry less about the destruction we're doing to the environment? I know the people that come out of the woodwork saying, oh, you're one of those things, you don't think global warming's happening. Nope, global warming's happening. Let me just clear that up real quick. All you tree huggers out there, let me clear it up. Global warming is happening. Because we're coming out of an ice age. It's the end of an ice age period. The earth was frozen solid. It's been melting ever since. It gets to a point where it'll all be melted, and guess what happens then? Some geological anomaly happens, and oh, by the way, the whole thing will freeze over again and we'll start again. Geologically, I could show you where that's happened numerous times to the surface of the earth. Oh, but our cars and our carbon monoxide and all the pollutants and everything's hurrying it along. Yeah, by a few years, not by thousands of years. But people just bought what Al Gore said. And the reason I'm talking about all this is not only does this thing aggravate me here in the newspaper, but then I saw this morning. Luke, you know who Harry Styles is?
Yes.
Who is Harry Styles?
I'm pretty sure he's part of a band.
Yes, he is.
Part of a boy band.
Yes.
Yeah, One Direction, is that
he's
correct?
He's the 2015 version. They're the 2010, 2011, 2015 version. 2010 versions of, like, New Kids on the Block or NSYNC, something like that. Would that be fair to say?
Right, yes. They all go in the same group.
Right. So, now, do you know who what's the actress's name that plays Arya Stark on Game of Thrones? Let me look it up real quick. Arya Stark. Because Harry Styles this weekend in San Diego was doing a Maisie Williams is her name, the actress. Harry Styles was doing, they were having a concert in San Diego. And Harry Styles tried to make a joke and all goes, do you like dolphins? And the crowd goes wild and everything. He said, well, don't go to SeaWorld, then they kill him. Well, Maisie Williams put that on her Twitter account, said, you heard him, folks, don't go to SeaWorld, to her 1.2 million followers. So now this Harry Styles quick video has went viral. Don't go to SeaWorld. Dolphins aren't safe at SeaWorld. Do you know how many times SeaWorld rushes out to take dolphins off the beach in Flagler and in New Smyrna and Daytona and all that beach yourselves or get stuck or have like wire and stuff wrapped around them so they beach yourselves and the people, the doctors and the veterinarians at SeaWorld take them, doctor them back to health and then release them to the wild? That's what people do. It's just like this flag issue. People only hear what they want to hear. The Blackwater thing with SeaWorld. Oh, they're killing orcas and they're mistreating them. And they, you know, a lot of orcas that they have at SeaWorld that they use in the entertainment part were born in captivity anyway and don't know the wild. But they save whales and they save sea turtles and they save dolphins and they put them back into the wild. To throw a blanket statement out, don't go to SeaWorld if you like dolphins, is ridiculous. And that's the problem we have in this world, is that little 15-second snippet. Without doing any research, without looking it up or anything, Harry Styles said it must be true. And Luke, now you can attest, because I'm not real sure who Harry Styles is, but you can attest he has a following. Is that safe to say?
He has a following, and most of them fall in the age range of about 14 or 15 years old of girls.
So very impressionable.
Very, yeah.
So they would think that if Harry Styles says don't go to SeaWorld, that SeaWorld's a bad thing. Would you think that that would be an accurate statement?
Right, right.
It's just, it's irresponsible in my opinion. Am I wrong in thinking that?
No, I don't understand why the statement was made. I don't know what his motives were. If he was just trying to be funny.
He was in San Diego, but trying to be funny. SeaWorld's right here near San Diego, you know, in San Diego.
Yeah.
He may have been, I don't know where the concert was. It may have been at a different amusement park in San Diego. I don't know. But just to throw a blanket, if you like dolphins, you love dolphins, don't go to SeaWorld. I mean, that's just terrible. All the good work that SeaWorld does, and I know that whole Blackwater movie, blah, 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 and the lady that got killed by the orca. SeaWorld does a ton of good for the ocean and the ecology of the ocean. And to throw that statement out there, just like, you know, with the Silver Springs issue. They don't want you to swim in it. The tree huggers don't want you to swim in it because it can harm the ecology. Buddy learned to swim in Silver Springs. People learned to swim. It didn't harm the water. What's harming the water at Silver Springs is septic tanks leaching into the springs. Okay? That's what's harming the springs. The animal waste and all from animals that didn't belong there, the elephants and giraffes and all at the little zoo, whatever they had, that's what hurt the springs. I hate people that just see things black and white. There's no compromise, no gray area. And I think that's the problem we're dealing with in almost every facet of society nowadays, Luke, and I just want to buy a little island somewhere and just go and be by myself. World would probably think it was a much better place if I'd just disappear like that anyway. We're going to take a break. We come back. It's Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom. Luke, I got great stuff to give away. I got Mojo's gift cards. I got a $25 gift card towards a haircut and a shave at R&R, a luxury barbershop, Bob Wine's Camellia Garden, La Famiglia Pizzeria. Coming up at hour two, it's a restaurant and food show. Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill will be here. Also, hour three, Buddy Martin joins the show live from Hoover, Alabama. He said Coach Spurrier was pure gold this morning. We'll learn all about that. All that on today's show. But next, Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom, your chance to win 622-9622. Let me go ahead and throw a question out there, Luke. Give somebody time to think about it. Here's the question. What band offered online pay what you want? That's good because you can Google that one pretty good. What band offered online pay what you want pricing for their 2007 album entitled In Rainbows? What band offered online pay for what you want pricing for their 2007 album In Rainbows? If you know that answer, give us a call, 622-9622. You answer that one correct, you get a follow-up question. You answer that one correct, and you will win a... What should we give away today? What do you think, Luke? We'll give away to Mojo's Grill first. We'll give that away. Coming up next, right here on the Voice of Ocala, Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Do you remember when summer was a celebration? You know, no schools, no worries, just days packed with your favorite pastime. It was the splendid season you dreamed of all year long. But as you got older and busier, the summer seemed to lose its sparkle. Where did those carefree days go? Well, they're closer than you think. Summer's still sensational at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, where you can come out and play the grown-up way with our affordable summer memberships. Enjoy our championship golf course celebrating the game's greatest holes, Hartrue Tennis Courts, and a state-of-the-art fitness center. Explore our stately 77,000 square foot clubhouse and unwind at our relaxing spa.
Don't forget the pool!
It's a summer unlike any other, and it's yours with a Golden Ocala summer membership. You can call Golden Ocala at 629-6229 to inquire about a summer membership, or you can visit goldenocala.com to learn more. That's goldenocala.com.
Weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today with a thunderstorm around during the afternoon hours, high 90 to 94. Tonight, partly cloudy. There can be a thunderstorm in spots near the coast early on, though 73 to 77. Tomorrow, partly sunny. Watch out for an afternoon thunderstorm, high 89 to 93. Thursday, sunshine mixing with clouds with a couple of thunderstorms around, mainly during the afternoon hours, the high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood. And when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Mayo Medical Center. Wow, they made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Mayo treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Mayo will help you.
Call New Mayo Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
Robin, let's try a little plant trivia. Name this nursery. It's a not-for-profit, and it teaches growing and caring for plants to their students.
Oh, that's easy. Kenny's Place.
Or how about this one? It's a nursery conveniently located between Ocala and Bellevue.
Again, it's Kenny's Place.
Or how about this one? A nursery with a wide variety of just what you need or want at the most reasonable prices.
Kenny's Place, of course.
Kenny's Place at 7677 Southeast 41st Court. Give them a call at 867-1213. It's a caring place for people and plants. It's Kenny's Place.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala Tribute Tuesday with Tom. What band offered online pay-for-what-you-want pricing for their 2007 album, In Rainbows? You know, that's the Google question, folks. You just look that up on the internet. It's the second question you don't have very much time to look up. 622-9622 for your chance to win a $10 gift card to Mojo Grill and Catering Company. We'll leave that one out there for about 2 or 3 minutes, Luke, and if we don't get anybody, we'll ask another question. What band offered online pay-for-what-you-want pricing for their 2007 album, In Rainbows? 622-9622. I keep laughing at all these people in cow outfits that are going, walking by in and out of the mall. I guess it's a free sandwich day at Chick-fil-A or something if you dress up like a cow. I mean, so I should just walk in and say, look at this belly I got. That's cowish. Give me a sandwich. You think that'd work, Luke?
I think that would be.
I think I should give it a try.
I think you should.
Well, you knew that this was going to happen. And Sunday's Florida Southern Pride Ride had a lot of residents in that area where the livestock pavilion is, saying that they were intimidated by the participants of the Pride Ride driving through their neighborhoods with the Confederate flag and everything, and they were intimidated by them. Meantime, the answer to gunshots that were heard in the area still haven't been answered for me. Well, the apartment complexes that are in the area, North Road Apartments, Ocala Place Apartments, and Pavilion Oak Apartments, those are the apartment complexes that the people said they were intimidated by. Most of those residents in the complexes, in those complexes, are African American. Well, Jessica Drum, who is the property manager at Ocala Place, said, according to this story on Ocala.com, said she received a lot of calls saying people were, you know, I'm hearing shots fired. We got people riding through the neighborhood with Confederate flags. What are you going to do about it? So she decided, she had so many complaints that she was going to go back, look at the surveillance footage, and if she could find anything where her residents were being harassed, she was going to turn it over to police. That sounds like a very good apartment manager, doesn't it, Luke? Sounds like a pretty good job. So she goes back. She looks at the surveillance system. She said, I didn't see any motorcycles or trucks with Confederate flags riding through my apartment complex, but I did find a man walking quickly through my complex with a cloth covering something in his hand. When the cloth was removed, it looked like it was a gun. She said, I work hard to clean up this area. If any of my tenants are involved, they'll be gone. So there is now video. You can go see it on Ocala.com. There's video of an African-American man carrying what appears to be a shotgun away from the pavilion area going back to this apartment complex. Might this be the shots that were fired? I don't know. But he was running away quickly from the area of this apartment complex that's back towards the pavilion. And there were reports of shots being fired. And it's clear on the video that he's running away. And when he removes the towel and throws it over his shoulder, you can see that it's a shotgun with a pistol grip on it. It's clear. You know, the paper's saying it looks like a shotgun. I've seen the video. It was clear a shotgun. You can see the stock and everything. This is what we've devolved into. This is where we're at now. Wonderful. Thanks, Bill Kaufman. What band offered online pay-per-view, pay-for-what-you-want pricing for their 2007 album, In Rainbows? I'm going to go ahead and give the answer to that, Luke. Radiohead. You got Radiohead on MP3 right now, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I knew that. Let me ask an easier question. Maybe I get some questions somebody actually knows. When I picked the question out and started reading it already, I was like, you know, because it's random. I just pick them out and read them. Okay, here we go. What magazine is famous for its condensed books? What magazine is famous for its condensed book? Give me a call, 622-9622. If you know that answer, you answered it correctly. I'll ask you a follow-up. You get that right, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo Grill and Catering Company. What magazine is famous for its condensed books? Let's go out to the phone lines. Hi, caller. Who's this?
This is Ed Jennings.
Hey, Ed, how are you?
Hey, Tom, how you doing today?
If I got any better, I wouldn't know the difference, Ed.
Oh, well, we need to keep those Confederate flags flying, buddy.
Well, you know, I just say that if it's caused this much divisiveness, Ed, and you fly it in your yard, fly it on your fence, put it up wherever, fly it in your truck, drive around with it, do whatever you want. If Bill Kaufman had left well enough alone, I don't think we'd be in the position we were in now.
I like Bill, so I commend him.
So what's the answer to that question?
I'd say Reader's Digest.
Reader's Digest is correct, Ed. Reader's Digest is correct. Let's go. This question, if you get this right, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo's. In the movie Easy Rider, what city are Wyatt and Billy headed to?
Oh, my goodness. I know Jack Nicholson is in that.
5 seconds.
I'd have to say Portland, Oregon.
Portland, Oregon is not correct, Ed. Thanks for playing, though.
Okay, thanks there.
Thanks for playing Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom. That's the question out there now. In the movie Easy Rider, what city are Wyatt and Billy headed to? If you know that answer, give me a call. 622-9622. We'll take your calls after the break. This is Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom on WOCA Radio. Up next, in the movie Easy Rider, what city are Wyatt and Billy headed to? You'll have a chance to win a $10 gift card for Bojo Grill and Catering Company. Answer it right. I'll give you a second question. Answer it right. You'll be a winner. Coming up now, hour number two, the Restaurant and Food Show. Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. And then Buddy Martin joins us live from SEC Media Days. All that today on a Tuesday afternoon. It's Trivia Night of Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Do you experience body aches, joint or muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research, 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today. If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Lakeware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Lakeware. Seating now available.
Fox News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. Congress has 60 days to look over the Iran nuclear deal, and some sound like they'll be perusing it carefully.
Based on what I know now, it doesn't look like a very good deal. I want to review all the facts.
House Speaker John Boehner, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu also not happy with the deal. The president has called him to assure him of our commitment to Israel's security. A hearing shortly for Alexander Ciccolo, son of a Boston police captain. He's accused of plotting a Boston Marathon-style attack on a university.
Court documents also reveal that agents found partially constructed Molotov cocktails at Ciccolo's apartment and witnessed him buying a pressure cooker on July 3rd, just the day before he was taken into custody. Sources say it's his father that first alerted authorities to a radical change in the younger man who has suffered with mental illness since childhood.
Fox's Molly Line, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
Bye.
For generation after generation, America's heroes have been fighting for our freedoms. And it's those freedoms that have allowed us here at Mike Scott Plumbing to prosper and grow in this great land of ours. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we help thousands of customers every day with everything from irrigation to repairing the kitchen sink. But if there's one thing that absolutely, positively needs to be maintained, it's your septic system. If you don't maintain your septic system, it could fail completely, leaving you with a big bill and an even bigger mess. So we here at Mike Scott Plumbing would like to help all of those who have helped us. If you have your septic pumped and you're a veteran, we would like to extend to you a special discount. Just mention this ad. Please call our office to schedule your appointment today, 866-314-4443. And from all of us here at Mike Scott Plumbing, thank you for your service.
Hey folks, we're still talking about that fabulous truckload tree sale at Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, and you know why? Because this is truly an event not to be missed. Bob's prices on trees are always the lowest in town, but during this truckload tree sale, they're even better. Bonafide savings of 33 to 66%, depending on which tree and what size. Example, a loquat, a red maple, Bob usually sells for $39.99, just $19.99 during this sale. Dozens of varieties, hundreds of trees, all on sale. And listen, giant selection of fruit trees, including peach, plum, nectarine, apple, and pear, regularly $39.99, but you buy one and you get one free. Hurry though, shop early for special summer store hours, daily till 3, Saturdays till 2. Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, Southeast 38th Street, homegrown, locally owned since 1952.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Let's go right out to the phone lines. Hi, caller. Who's this?
How you doing, Tom?
Hey, Kevin. Hey, Kevin. How you doing? In the movie.
Doing great.
In the movie. What you want to talk about something before we get to the movies?
Oh no, no, you're good.
In the movie Easy Rider, what city are Wyatt and Billy headed to?
Would that be New Orleans?
It would be New Orleans. All right. Now. Next question, you get it right, you'll win a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grilling Catering Company. How many flavors does Dr. Pepper claim it has in its blend? 20, 21, 22, or 23?
I'm going to go with...
5 seconds.
21.
Ooh, 23 is the correct answer. 23 is the correct answer. Hey, thanks for playing Tribunator Tuesday with Tom.
All right, thanks a lot, Tom. Appreciate it.
Yep, let's go out and get another question out there. Get another question so people can call in. Let me get one ready here, Luke. Here's a question. Well, that's just too easy. Okay, here's one. How many times does Beetlejuice's name have to be repeated in order to send him back to the tiny model town? How many times does Beetlejuice's name have to be repeated in order to send him back to the tiny model town? If you know that answer, give me a call, 622-9622, for your chance to win a Mojo Grilling Catering gift card for $10. We still got an R&R Luxury Barbershop $25 gift certificate for a haircut and shave, a $20 Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens gift certificate, and a La Famiglia $10 gift certificate. La Famiglia is 2506 Southeast 17th Street, Bob Wine's 2610 Southeast 38th Street, and of course, R&R Luxury Barbershops at 9 East Fort King. We still got those to give away, but right now we're going to give this Mojo's card away. Hi, caller, who's this?
This is Tim.
Tim, how many times does Beetlejuice's name have to be reported in order to send him back to the tiny model town?
Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice. 3 times.
That is correct. Let's ask you one more question. I hope you get this right. You can win this $10 gift card.
All right, sir.
In whose honor was the University of Virginia's Raven Society established?
In whose honor was...
The University of Virginia's Raven Society established. 5 seconds.
Joe Montana.
Joe Montana is not the correct answer.
I apologize. I'm sorry.
Thanks for playing Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. Hi, caller. Who's this? Hello, caller.
Hey, this is Brett.
Hey, Brett. How are you today?
Good.
Brett, in whose honor was the University of Virginia's Raven Society established?
Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan Poe is correct. All right, this is such an easy question, but I got to ask it. What does POTUS stand for?
President of the United States.
That is correct. Brett, what's the last initial? What's the first initial of your last name?
B, as in Bravo.
All right, Brett B. Brett, you'll be able to pick up your Mojo's gift card, $10 gift card, at the front of the radio station starting at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Thanks, Tom. See you later.
Thanks. Thanks for playing Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. All right, Luke, that's giving that away. Let's give away this $25 gift certificate to R&R Luxury Barbershop. It's for a haircut and a shave, towards a haircut and a shave. Joe's actually out there preening now wanting to win this. What pirate's treasure is at the center of the kid's search in the movie The Goonies? What pirate's treasure is at the center of the kid's search in the movie Goonies? 622-9622 if you know that answer. And get that right. Follow-up question, you'll be a winner of a $25 towards services from R&R Luxury Barbershop towards a haircut and a shave. That's at 9 East Fort King Street. We still got the $10 gift card from La Famiglia Pizzeria to give away there at 2506 Southeast 17th Street and a $10 gift certificate and a $20 Bob Wines Camellia Gardens at $20 worth of plants from Bob Wines. They're at 2610 Southeast 38th Street. So give me a call, 622-9622, if you know what's the name of the pirate whose treasure is at the center of the kid's search in The Goonies. 622-9622. You know, when's the madness going to stop? The madness needs to stop. My friend of mine sent me this, a well-respected lawyer in Atlanta, who I went to college with, Ryan Eisenberg of Eisenberg and Hewitt, a law firm in Atlanta, sent me this story, and I thought he was just kidding me. Clint Lewis has just walked in the building. We're going to get Clint right to the microphone, because I saw this story, and I thought, you know, when is this going to end? We've talked ad nauseum about the flag and everything. We've got to put that to bed. But on the heels of taking the flag down because it's hatred and it's hate speech and everything, now the Atlanta chapter of the NAACP is wanting this. The NAACP officially called for the elimination of all symbols of the Confederacy on Tuesday, including the sandblasting off of the generals of the Confederate Army from Stone Mountain Park. The time to move is now. He said, this is Richard Rose, the NAACP spokesman. When I'm out here, I have to be honest, when I'm out here enjoying Stone Mountain, I'm thinking what it has to offer and what I'm coming for. The NAACP has much serious port. It said the statement calling for the removal of all symbols, my tax dollars should not be used to commemorate slavery. I want the Confederate symbol removed from all state-owned buildings, parks, and lands. He would start with Jefferson Davis, Robert E. Lee, and Stonewall Jackson. Those guys need to go. They need to be sandblasted off, or somebody could carefully remove a slab of that and auction it off to the highest bidder, but it needs to go. It's offensive. What? Have you lost your damn mind?
He doesn't want his tax dollars, but he's going to want to spend tax dollars to have it removed?
Of course.
Okay.
See, that right there, I'm glad you realized that right away. You know, if we're gonna do that, I mean, you know, Washington owned slaves. We got to take the Washington Monument down. Jefferson owned slave, Jefferson Memorial. It's got to come down. I mean, really? The Liberty Bell rang in Philadelphia when slavery was still legal in Philadelphia. Got to come down. Independence Hall, where they wrote the Declaration of Independence. Philadelphia at the time had slaves. Got to come down.
Right. There might be a line, but the line is not there.
Good night. Let's go right up to the phone lines. Hi, caller. Who's this? Hey, Alex. Alex, I know who it is, buddy. I know who it is. Hey, what's the answer to the Goonies question, Alex?
It's one-eyed Willie.
It certainly is, Alex. It certainly is. Alex, we're gonna just go ahead and give Alex the prize there, because Alex is my buddy, and he got that. Alex, you won. You got a $25 gift card to R&R Luxury Barbershop, buddy. Hey, thanks for listening, Alex.
Okay.
Have a good day.
You guys, have a good day.
Bye-bye. That's Alex. He's a loyal listener to the show. He listens to the show. He keeps us going, too. If we ever go offline, Alex will call Patsy and let her know right away, hey, camera's not up. Get that fixed. So we go ahead and let Alex win the R&R gift certificate. Let's ask another question. It's Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom, but Clint Lewis walked in, so I had to get him to help me so I didn't lose my mind over, you know, guy literally wants sandblast. So what are we going to do? We're going to go sandblast George Washington, Thomas Jefferson off Mount Rushmore? They owned slaves.
Yeah, it never ends with that.
They lived in Virginia. Virginia was a slave state. We're going to just sandblast them off Mount Rushmore? We're going to change the name of the state of Washington to something else? Stop. I mean, come on. All right, Trivia Tuesday with Tom. What DJ was the voice of Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo TV series? What DJ was the voice of Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo TV series? 622-9622 if you know that answer. Right now we're giving away a $20 gift card to Bob Wine's Camellia Garden. $20 gift card to Bob Wine's Camellia Garden. What DJ was the voice of Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo TV series? 622-9622 if you know that answer. We're going to take a break. Come back for the break. We'll wrap up hour number one, get you ready for the restaurant and food show in hour number two. Right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Are you one of those golfers that use the .coms to try to find the best deal available every day of the week? Well, why use a middleman? For $100, you can be a summer member at Pine Oaks of Ocala. And what do you get with your Pine Oaks membership? Well, you get to play all the golf that you want in the afternoons, and all you do is pay the cart fee. $8 for 9 holes or $12 for 18 holes. This is the golf deal of the summer. Don't miss it. That's the $100 summer membership at Pine Oaks of Ocala.
Are you looking for a durable farm fence to keep your horses enclosed, or a beautiful vinyl fence to give that finishing touch to your home? Seminole Fence has over 20 years of experience in providing quality fence products and services for farm and residential properties. Let them surround your property with a fence that provides privacy, security, and stunning appeal. Don't wait. Contact them today at 352-208-0959 for a free estimate. Seminole Fence, working hard to build fences and harder to build relationships.
Who doesn't love heading out on the boat with a family, hitting the ATV trails with friends, or blazing new stretches of highway with riding buddies? Your toys are your ticket to outdoor fun. At the McDonald Allstate Agency, we get to know you and help make sure you have all the right coverages. Plus, when you bundle your coverage for your car and your home with your boat, motorcycle, RV, or more, you can save up to 30%. So call the McDonald Allstate Agency today at 622-2333 or stop by one of our two Ocala locations at Cala Hills or the Jasmine Square Plaza.
Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Locally owned and operated since 1957, we are The Source, 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today with a thunderstorm around during the afternoon hours, high 90 to 94. Tonight, partly cloudy. There can be a thunderstorm in spots near the coast early on, though 73 to 77. Tomorrow, partly sunny. Watch out for an afternoon thunderstorm, high 89 to 93. Thursday, sunshine mixing with clouds with a couple of thunderstorms around, mainly during the afternoon hours, the high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
This weather brought to you by OcalaForSale.com, where you too can be a sellout. Give them a call at 629-1663 or just go to OcalaForSale.com. I'm a
sellout. We're saving thousands with Robert Palmer.
So rule number one is always shop around.
Always shop around.
If you're trying to get a mortgage, if you're trying to get the best credit card, if you're looking at student loans, cell phone bills, you name it, rule number one is always shop around.
Always shop around.
That's rule number one, just one more vital part of fighting back to stop being a financial zombie. Yes, you can take the mystery out of the complicated world of finances. Take charge when it comes to your money. Listen in on The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM, Saturdays at 12:05.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
WOCA AM 1370. 96.3 FM.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Voice of Ocala, Tribute Into Tuesday with Tom. The question out there on the docket right now, what DJ was the voice of Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo TV series? 622-9622 if you know that answer. Get that right, your answer. Follow-up question, you get the follow-up question right, and you'll win a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens. That's $20 worth of plants. Now, I don't know, y'all just had a bunch of plant work done at your home, which is also the office.
Yes.
Angelo State Pharmacy. But $20 worth of plants, you can get some pretty good annuals and perennials, a pretty good amount, I would think, for $20.
Yes, that would be a great start. Absolutely.
Yeah. Y'all got that little right around the Angelo sign, those annuals y'all have out there,
yes.
Perennials.
I
don't know whether they're annuals or perennials. I never know.
I don't either.
I never know. But that's a really nice arrangement. You had somebody do there.
Yeah, he did a great job. Leo.
I promise you weren't out there on your hands and knees planting those.
Nah, come on. I weed it every once in a while.
You do. Well, you got to. You got to make sure you weed that kind of thing because it'll just get run over. Tribunated Tuesday with Tom. What DJ was the voice of Shaggy in the Scooby-Doo TV series? 622-9622 for your chance to win a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens. So, you know, off the air, some of the best conversations take place. And Clint asked how my morning had went. I said I had a pretty good morning. He asked how Luke's went. And Luke said he had a pretty good morning. Got to play a little round ball around noon with some partners of his over there at the YMCA. Well, Clint, how was your day so far?
I've had a good morning. I've worked out this morning, got a good workout in, and then I was putting together a desk filing cabinet most of the rest of the time.
Now, let me ask you about that. That's a good question because – I'm not real mechanic. Matter of fact, I have zero mechanical ability. I'll ask you after the caller. We'll take the caller. Hi, caller. Who's this?
It's Steve.
Hey, Steve. How are you?
Good, good. How you doing?
Good. What DJ was the voice of Shaggy in Scooby-Doo TV series?
Was it Casey Kasem?
It was Casey Kasem. Let me give you a follow-up question. Get it right, you win $20 from Bob Wine's gift certificate from Bob Wine's Camellia Garden. All right. What creature's bite can lead to Lyme disease?
That would be a tick.
That is a tick. That is a tick. Steve, what's the first initial of your last name?
It is a B.
B. Steve B. Steve, thanks so much. You'll be able to pick up this gift certificate starting at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning.
All righty. Thank you.
All right. Have a great day. So that brings to a close Trivinator Tuesday with Tom right there. Three winners today.
Quick
pretty
answers.
Good.
Yeah.
I forgot where I was going here.
A desk. I put
the desk
together.
Yeah, you put the desk together. I've only tried one thing like that, and I picture that filing cabinets and desks like that you have to assemble would probably be a lot like those little aluminum buildings that you have to put together that the holes never line up and they're never drilled in the right place and everything. It really is a effort to do. Is that pretty much how a desk and filing cabinet is as well?
Yes, for the most part. This one's going pretty good, though. It's always frustrating when you get something that doesn't have the right part, missing pieces. But I've noticed over the years, back whenever it's Christmas and we've got all these toys to put together, the instructions are so much better now than they used to be.
Oh, yeah.
You don't even have to be able to read to put things together.
Well, I tell you,
it's great.
A would be,
exactly.
And C would be.
Everything's labeled and bagged.
Have you ever put one of those little aluminum buildings together, though?
I haven't.
It is because you got to put the track out, then you got to put the panels up. Then the panels, you screw them together, but they never, the holes never, it's a pain in the. So finally, I just went and drilled my own holes and put the screws in. And so,
it works. Hope for the best, right?
Coming up next, Restaurant and Food Show. Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill will be here. Clint Lewis is with us. I'll be here. I'm always about restaurant and food. I can talk some food. Luke pressing all the right buttons. Hopefully we'll have Buddy Martin at 5:15 pressing all the right buttons as he's live from Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days. Coming up next, there he is. I see the chef walking by the window. Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill next, the Restaurant and Food Show, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day, whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands. At Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go.
Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige, it's all there in our name.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer up charge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed, but never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field, and now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service, and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 840-0750. That's 840-0750.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
WOCA
1370 WOCA.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. President Obama says the Iran nuke deal will stop the spread of nuclear weapons in that region. New York Times Tehran Bureau Chief Thomas Erdbrink says they're celebrating in the streets.
People are waving Iranian flags, holding up cell phones and balloons. And they're thanking the nuclear negotiating team. And of course, they are so happy because the normal, ordinary Iranians that you never hear about are actually hoping for a better future with less extremism and less tension with the West.
Meanwhile, Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu's blasting the deal, saying the world is now less safe. Some GOP presidential hopefuls are speaking out against the president and his deal, among them Jeb Bush.
If you don't believe in his nuanced, naive view, as many on the left now ascribe to, you're a warmonger.
Congress has 60 days to approve or reject the agreement. Closing arguments have begun in the Colorado movie theater massacre case. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for for you as well. At TermBusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call TermBusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind, because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Welcome back to hour number two of The Voice of Ocala on a Tuesday afternoon. That means it's time for the restaurant and food show. Dave Del Rio, the chef at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, he's here as always. Good afternoon, Dave. How are you?
You know what? I couldn't be better. What a great day.
It's a perfect day. Sun's high in the sky. You know, and I like the warm temperature. So I love summers in Florida. And you love summers in Florida because that means the doors are open, the beach is open, the breeze is blowing through, and
that's
a good day at Eaton's Beach.
It's a good day. We're firing on all cylinders. We got the bass boats out there, and I might sneak out a little bit later on tonight, too, as a matter of fact. So.
Now, I heard something the other day. Somebody told me that, and I wanted to ask you if this was right or not, that jet skis are available for rental at Eaton's Beach now?
Yes, they are. We are renting jet skis there now.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah,
that's great.
Right now it's on the weekends, and come up there. There's a number that you can call, and of course I'm gonna have to find out what that number, because I don't remember off the top of my head.
Well, Susan always finds out the numbers for you.
She'll know what it is. we do them on the weekends, and it's been really fun. We've had a lot of people. They kind of go all the time.
Well, you know, I specifically go to Blue Gator in Dunellen.
Mm-hmm.
Not the food is adequate and everything. It's fuel, you know. Mm-hmm. But I go there because you can rent jet skis or boats to get on the river. Now there's no reason to go there because I can rent jet skis at Lake Weir. So I just come out to Eaton's Beach all the time.
There you go. We got jet skis, you know. Yeah,
Eaton's Beach is closer than Dunellen for me. I can just go right to Eaton's Beach now.
That's right. That's right. But you know, I will say something though. And not that I don't want you to come over there, but on that river, that's pretty cool.
That is nice. The river's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
The river's pretty cool over there.
You know what gets me is when you go, like, where it goes from the Withlacoochee to the rainbow,
uh-huh.
that divider line where it's clear
and then murky. Oh, yeah.
How does that work?
And it's almost like they drew a straight line. It's right there.
That's what it looks like.
It goes from murky to straight to clear.
That's a mystery in my mind.
I don't know how, because, you know, you can go from, like, the St. John's River, you get eventually up high enough in St. John's River, you can start tasting the salt water when you get in the water and everything because of the brackish. You would think the murky and the clear would mix somehow, and they don't. It's almost like there's a barrier.
That's right.
It's like a black and tan, Tom.
Huh?
Black and tan.
It's like a black and tan. Again, I said.
No, because even with the black and tan, sometimes it filters down into it a little bit.
You're right.
Yeah, well, I'm talking to a guy that used to pour Guinnesses correctly, so. Got a special guest in the studio today. Cindy Nicholson, not with us from Mark's Prime Seafood Steak and Seafood, but we do have a special guest in, an actual TV star, if it was, Dave. Why don't you tell us about that?
You know, I got to tell you, I'm really excited to have him here. He is, we haven't had a chance to catch up, but he doesn't know a lot about me yet, but I know about him. He's one of the nine finalists on the next Grilling Star, is that what it's called?
Search for America's new grill star.
He was just on with Kelly Ripa and Michael on Friday, and he's one of the finalists. And let me tell you something. He's got a really great burger there that I'm gonna have a few questions on, because I'm also of a Hispanic background. So I looked at it over, and I was like, oh, that sounds really good. So anyway, let's welcome Jose Juarez, local guy, doing great.
Now, thanks for being here, Jose. Good to have you.
Hey, thanks for having me here.
Now, where are you a chef at?
I am not a chef. I'm a chef at 636 Southeast 45th Terrace, my house. it's a hobby. I come home from work, and one of the things I love doing is I love creating. I love cooking on the grill. It's a way to relax, and that's basically my grill is on. I'd have to say 6 out of 7 days. I might be 7, but
well,
at least
you just said on, so you already cleared up one question for me, because you know, in the grilling world,
mm-hmm.
You're either charcoal or you're gas. You're one or the other. And what are you? I get your gas because you said the grill's on.
I'm both.
Are you both?
I've got 5 grills.
Wow. Five grills.
Yeah. So it's not, I'm not a one grill guy. I do have a 5 burner gas. And then in the office, I have a 3 burner gas because I cook there for our office staff at Victory Solutions. And then I have something called a cajachina, which is charcoal. It's basically. And then I have 2 smokers, which on the end of them, they also have a charcoal grill. So I'm diverse in the grill world.
My dad, when I was growing up, I started grilling when I was a young kid because my dad was an auto mechanic, but he would host Sunday parties. We'd get home from Catholic Church Sunday morning because he was an 8 o'clock mass guy. So, because he wasn't going to miss the NFL. So, he's 8 o'clock mass guy. We get home about 9:15, 9:20. And he would go out and he'd start the grill up. And when I say grill, my dad took 3 55-gallon drums and welded them together. Yep. The whole length.
That's, yeah.
And he had it where it cut. And he had a grill. You know, it's probably 6.5-foot-long grill that he was sat down in there. And he would take the charcoal and put from one end, use like 6 bags of charcoal, and he would put it from one end to the other. And we had this old garbage can sitting over there that was full of water with a lid on it. He would take those bourbon-soaked chips out of that water he'd been soaking and throw those on there, and he would cook for 40, 50 people every Sunday. So as soon as I was older, he didn't want me working on cars because he was a mechanic and he didn't want me to bust my knuckles. But as soon as I was old enough to belly up to that grill, he was showing me spatulas and how heat worked and everything. So grilling is the one thing that I really look forward to. And 5 grills, Dave.
You know, that's something. That's more than I got to admit, you know. 5 grills.
Now, I would think this is something you do almost every weekend.
Oh yeah, I mean, I'm telling you, it's every night. You know, a lot of times my neighbors and one of my neighbors, Randy Buss, he becomes my test kitchen because I'll call him at 11 o'clock at night. You know, sometimes, and I'll just sit there. Yeah, you know, I'm Cuban. I eat late, so it's one of those things.
Gotcha.
where I'll call him up and say, hey, I just came up with something. But every piece of equipment kind of has its job. The cajachina, that's for a whole pig, you know, and I've done that on a couple occasions. I've got a smoker for fish because I don't like to mix it in because the fish is so strong. If you mix that smoker, it doesn't work. I've got another one for all kinds of other meats, you know, and then, of course, the gas grill.
The gas grills, and that's something else. That you said you got a grill just for cooking the whole hog.
Yep.
Where I cook a whole hog by digging a hole in the ground.
Yep,
that's how I do it.
You know, kind of the same principle with a cajachina,
it
though.
Is it really?
Cajachina means Chinese box.
Oh, okay, so it's just a hot box.
So yeah, I mean it's real similar kind of process, but I'm gonna tell you something. They work great. I've cooked many a pig in a cajachina.
I get friends of mine say, "You dig a hole? What?" I'm South Georgia. We dig a hole and cook a hog in a hole.
South Florida, same. I mean, every Christmas growing up as a kid, we would have the whole hog and we would dig the hole.
Right.
And, you know, there's different ways of doing it. I personally haven't done that, but, years ago, a good friend of mine, John McLeod, actually gave me the cajachina, you know, and then from there, I just
like
started.
City Councilman John McLeod?
Yeah, yeah. So
you just publicly said he's a good friend of yours?
I would
retract that. I'd retract that quickly.
He's a great friend.
Wait, he's probably fixing to text me and go, watch it, Mr. Schmitz. I actually talked to your good friend John McLeod this morning. He called me this morning. I was watching Game of Thrones. He interrupted me watching Game of Thrones, the guy.
Well, I've known John on for over 20 years, and you know, he said, "I want a good Cuban to give this to," and which was great because it went to good use, and we've cooked lots of hogs on that bad boy.
We're gonna take a break. We come back, Chef Dave Del Rio will start quizzing Jose Juarez on exactly what it was he cooked for Kelly and Michael that became that made him a semifinalist.
Inquiring minds want to know.
Next on the Restaurant and Food Show, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Do you remember when summer was a celebration? You know, no schools, no worries, just days packed with your favorite pastime. It was the splendid season you dreamed of all year long. But as you got older and busier, the summer seemed to lose its sparkle. Where did those carefree days go? Well, they're closer than you think. Summer's still sensational at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, where you can come out and play the grown-up way with our affordable summer memberships. Enjoy our championship golf course celebrating the game's greatest holes, hard-true tennis courts, and a state-of-the-art fitness center. Explore our stately 77,000-square-foot clubhouse and unwind at our relaxing spa.
Don't forget the pool!
It's a summer unlike any other, and it's yours with a Golden Ocala summer membership. You can call Golden Ocala at 629-6229 to inquire about a summer membership, or you can visit goldenocala.com to learn more. That's goldenocala.com.
Central Florida is well known for our love of horses, and here at Seminole Fence Company, we have over 20 years of experience in providing quality fence products and services for farm and residential properties. Let us surround your property with a fence that provides privacy, security, and of course, stunning appeal. Don't wait. Contact us today at 352-208-0959 for a free estimate. Seminole Fence Company, working hard to build fences, working harder to build relationships.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75 exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt golf, and the car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today with a thunderstorm around during the afternoon hours, high 90 to 94. Tonight, partly cloudy. There can be a thunderstorm in spots near the coast early on, though 73 to 77. Tomorrow, partly sunny. Watch out for an afternoon thunderstorm, high 89 to 93. Thursday, sunshine mixing with clouds with a couple of thunderstorms around, mainly during the afternoon hours, the high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood. And when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Male Medical Center. Wow, they made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Male treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Male will help you.
Call New Male Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to the Restaurant and Food Show here on the Voice of Ocala. Every Tuesday with Chef Dave Del Rio, the co-host, although Buddy's not here today. He is at SEC Media Days in Hoover, Alabama. He'll be checking in after the next break with us. But Chef Del Rio is here from Eat and Beat Sandbar and Grill. And Chef, I turn it over to you. It's time to find out about this Cuban burger.
I'm going to grill this guy.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
Okay. So you really are an amateur at this, right?
Absolutely, 100%.
Okay, how did you get involved in this Kelly and Michael deal?
Well, I'm a fan of the show, you know, and I do watch the show. You know, with my business, we deal with motorcycle dealers across the country. So I usually get in around 10 o'clock, and then I'll stay till 8, 9 o'clock. So I'm kind of the night shift there. And so I'll watch the show at 9 o'clock, and they had this contest going on, America's Next Grill Star. And it sounded interesting, but honestly, I would have never done it if it wasn't for my wife, Kelly, where she was like, hey, you need to do this. And I was like hawing around, and, you know, and then finally she kind of drove me to the point where the rule was a 30-second video you had to send them on basically your story, what your sandwich is, and you know, what you make. So I sent that to them. Nice. And, you know,
it just took off from there, huh?
Well, I sent it to him, and I got contacted probably 7 days or 5 days afterwards with a few more questions, you know. And then from there, they basically, you know, I got notified in a very short notice that I was a number 6 semifinalist, and they flew Kelly and I up to New York.
Oh, cool.
Put us up in a hotel, had a driver. It was kind of like I call it like a Cinderella thing. You know, it's kind of funny. You're at the airport, you got your limo, you got your driver taking you to the hotel, and mm-hmm. you know, when you leave, the same thing, and then you end up in Orlando, pick up your car in a rainstorm. You know, I was looking to see
back
if my shoe
Earth.
Was missing.
Back to reality,
you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, now, it says August 14th, 2 finalists are going to compete.
Right.
In front of judges, and this is pretty good swag they get. The winner's going to get $10,000, star in 5 webisodes of live on the live website and AOL.com. Runner up, though, gets $2,500. So,
it's
not a bad day.
Better than a sharp stick in the eye, right? Yeah, I mean,
Now, here's the big question, the Cuban burger.
Right.
Well, now I got a question. Now, I used to do R&D. You know, research and development, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And I've had recipes that, you know, or ideas that I've been sitting on for years.
Right.
So is this one that just came to you, or have you been sitting on this for a long time?
No, this one is one that basically came to me. It's nothing I've been sitting on. I don't really sit on stuff because I'm not a professional like yourself. You know, so I don't look at, I'm going to do this later, whatever. I'm always playing with different flavors and different ideas. And, you know, and I've done a lot of, you know, pulled pork. I use a fresh ham, what I call a picnic ham.
Sure.
And, you know, so kind of like when I was thinking about what am I going to send him? It's a bit complex, but I did not want to just go up there and do something simple. I wanted something that was going to be complex, something that was going to have a lot of flavors. And I really thought, I want to marry, you know, something that's classic in the United States, the hamburger, and then something that's classic in Cuba, the Cuban sandwich, and then put them together. And some of the twists on it is that you know, the pulled pork on it is actually smoked. But then it sits in mojo for 4 hours before in the oven, and then it gets smoked for 4 hours. So when you bite into that, flat top part. You've got a smokiness, and then you've got that citrus mojo along with my burger. It's not an ordinary burger. I do a ribeye steak. I go to my butcher and basically tell him to grind it up as hamburger. So now I've got a medium rare ribeye steak burger. You know, I've got my pickles, which I put on the grill. Then on top of that, I've got my sweet sliced ham, Swiss cheese, and then I'm putting my pulled pork on top. And then, of course, you can't forget my 455 sauce. You know, that gets drizzled on top of it. And then
why do you call it the 455 sauce? I love this.
Well, the 455, you know, I love muscle cars. You know, since I was a kid, I was a huge Pontiac fan. You know, I can still remember the first time coming to the United States from Cuba. The first car I ever saw on the street that just impressed me was a 69 GTO Judge. Been a huge fan of Pontiacs.
It's a great car. Oh,
you know what? I got goosebumps.
It's a great car.
I'm telling you.
I have a 71 GTO convertible that was always my dream to have a GTO. When Kelly and I were dating, I had that car back in school, so I've owned it over 30 years. So the engine in it is a 455. I kind of, as I was working up the sauce, one of the things that they had to have for the show, they said, we need exact measurements. I'm a guy that puts stuff together and throws it in there. So I had to start measuring it, and it came out to, you know, exact four parts, which was the you know, combination of the four tablespoons of mojo, five tablespoons of mustard, five tablespoons of mayo. Mix it again. There you got 455.
Couldn't have planned that.
No.
You know? Couldn't have made that up.
So it worked nice. I tell people, I was almost a 442, but I kept having to add a couple things. And then, you know, I told Michael that on the show, and he was funny. If he catch it, he looks over, he goes, that's an Olds. So he was into muscle cars.
That's right,
yeah.
That's right. So, okay, so what kind of bread does it have?
Cuban bread.
It is on Cuban bread.
It's on Cuban bread. So think about it. Traditionally, you got your Cuban bread. I put a little bit of that 455 sauce on the bottom of it. It gets toasted first, just slightly on the grill. Then the next layer is your Swiss cheese, and then you have your steak burger, and then you have your pickles, and then I take the sweet sliced ham, just put it on the grill just a little bit, a couple grill marks, you know, so it's not cold, a little crispy. It goes on top. Mm. My pulled pork, drizzle the 455 sauce. Sauce, a couple more slices of Swiss cheese, put the top on it and press it. My press was a little unique. It's funny, when I was on the show, you know, they asked me, they said, what is that? I said, it's a piston. And you know, and they were like, we know it's a piston. What's it here for? I said, I'm pressing my sandwich with it.
That's great.
You know, he's got ribeye ground up for the burger, pulled pork, which is a picnic ham. He's got all these great ingredients. And you know me, Dave, I love food. I'm thinking about all that food, and then he goes, 455 sauce, and explains that. Now all I can think about is when I was a kid, Mr. Britt, 67 GTO, that used to sit in his yard in a convertible. That's all I can think about now. I remember I wanted that GTO so bad. It was a 67 convertible GTO with the long body.
Nice car.
I wanted it so bad. I really wanted it. Now, so I've already lost track of thought on this food on the sandwich, because I'm thinking GTOs.
Yeah, well, I'm still thinking about that sandwich, though. You know.
So you it's an infusion of the traditional Cuban sandwich with an American burger, and I bet Michael probably thought that it was one of the best things he'd ever eaten.
Oh yeah, he loved it. I mean, they're very gracious, both of them. But I really, you know, and you, if you guys watched it, and you did, you know,
I watch the show every day. It's one of my favorite shows.
Me too. I mean, and he loved the sandwich. She did too. And it was kind of funny because, the executive producer Gilman, he comes down, and at the very end, when I did my final thing, that's when he tried some of the pork, and then he ended up going back up, which I hadn't seen that at that point. Mm-hmm. And was telling, you know, right. That's when Kelly was saying, wow, what was it that she said? I'm trying to remember.
I forget the exact quote, but
I wanted to lick you or right. Something.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to say that, yeah. Something about,
She, because usually when they get done with the food stuff, they go into some, but she made a point to say that she wanted to taste him again.
Something like that, because he smelled like barbecue.
And she had to be talking about that. She was stumbling around about that for at least a minute or so, you know. So.
But the experience in New York, talk about that experience. You said it's kind of like Cinderella, but was it there and gone in a flash?
No, I mean, you know, we got there, it was a couple days. It that day, yes, that day went by extremely fast over those few hours in the morning. But, you know, I mean, it was first class all the way. They flew my wife and I up and, you know, had a driver at the airport, put us up in a hotel. Interesting thing about it is, you know, literally a few hours before, I get called and they were like, we want you to make the pork yourself. Can you do that? Freeze it and bring it up here. So I did. So, you know, I'm going, here I am on Broadway with some pork heading over to the studio. You know, so, you know, some frozen
probably
pork,
not but, the probably not the weirdest thing New Yorkers are going to see.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Got to take a break. Coming up after the break, Buddy Martin will join us from Hoover, Alabama. He'll give us an update on Coach Steve Spurrier. And we'll find out more from Jose Juarez. Just about really what we're going to ask is when we come over Saturday to get this burger, Dave.
I was wondering about that. I'm surprised he didn't have one with him. I guess I should have asked.
We already have the address because he gave the address. So, you know, we already know where he lives.
Oh, and a couple hundred of our closest friends, right?
People probably missed that, but I got it on tape. We can go back and listen, Dave. We can GPS it. It'll be great. Because he says 11 o'clock at night, he's grilling.
That's so right.
Just look for the smoke.
It works on my schedule.
Yeah, works with your schedule. Exactly. Yeah, 11 o'clock at night works for your schedule. More coming up next with Jose Juarez, who is a finalist on the Live with Kelly and Michael search for America's new grill star. I think he just needs to contact the people in Orlando at the Food Network, Dave, and go ahead and get his own show.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Coming up next, Buddy Martin joins us live from Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, and then more Restaurant and Food Show right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
There's a car accident in this country every 5 seconds. That's why Allstate thinks it's time for an entirely different kind of car insurance, with features like accident forgiveness and a safe driving bonus. It's called Your Choice Auto, and it's only from Allstate. Are you in good hands?
You deserve better. Sign up for Your Choice Auto from Allstate. Call the McDonald Agency today at 622-2333.
Features are optional and subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Insurance, Northbrook, Illinois.
When you were a kid, you had all sorts of toys. Toy cars, boats, trucks, entire toy boxes full of fun. Of course, you never really outgrow your toys, do you? It's just that now, instead of a box full, you have a garage full. Cars, trucks, boats, motorcycles, ATVs, and more. As you get older, your love of toys just gets stronger. So protect those toys the best way possible by switching to Allstate. An Allstate agent can help do the switching, paperwork, bundle all your policies together, and even find you a bunch of discounts. So if you love your toys, make sure you protect your toys by making one call to an Allstate agent.
Protect all your toys with Allstate and the McDonald Agency. Established in 1985, we have offices in Ocala and the Villages to better serve you. Give us a call at 622-2333. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability.
Are you in good hands?
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. President Obama says the Iran nuke deal will stop the spread of nuclear weapons. New York Times Tehran Bureau Chief Thomas Erdbrink says they're celebrating in the streets.
People are waving Iranian flags, holding up cell phones and balloons, and they are thanking the nuclear negotiating team. And of course, they are so happy because the normal, ordinary Iranians that you never hear about are actually hoping for a better future with less extremism and less tension. with the West.
Meanwhile, Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu's blasting the deal, saying the world is now less safe. Some GOP presidential hopefuls are speaking out against the president and his deal, among them Jeb Bush.
If you don't believe in his nuanced, naive view, as many on the left now ascribe to, you're a warmonger.
Congress has 60 days to approve or reject the agreement. Closing arguments have begun in the Colorado movie theater massacre case. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At TermBusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call TermBusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
Pay your taxes. Eat your vegetables. Watch your weight. Mow the lawn. Clean the house. We all have stuff we don't want to do. Isn't it about time you did something you wanted to do? Like getting your pilot's license? At Ocala Aviation, they make it fun and easy. And you can start by taking one of their discovery flights. For only $99, you get to go up in the airplane with an FAA-certified flight instructor and actually fly the plane yourself. It's a perfect way to see if flying is for you. And once you get that ultimate feeling of freedom, Ocala Aviation can train you to get your pilot's license. Ocala Aviation also offers commercial flight training for those looking to make a career change and enter the world of commercial aviation. Ocala Aviation is conveniently located at the Ocala International Airport. So if you're ready to start your adventure, stop by or give them a call today. 861-7484. That's 861-7484. You'll be glad you did. I know I am. Ocala Aviation. Call today. 861-7484.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Ocala, the restaurant and food show. We're going to take a break for just for a minute from talking with Jose Juarez and Chef Dave Del Rio and go out to the hotline to Hoover, Alabama. If y'all want to put those headsets on, you can hear Buddy there a little better. Go out to Hoover, Alabama and talk to Buddy Martin live at SEC Media Days. Buddy, you got Chef Dave Del Rio and one of the semifinalists for Kelly and Michael's Next Grilling Star, America's Next Grilling Star, Jose Juarez on the line with you. What's going on up in Hoover?
Excuse me, Tom. I'm just finishing up my strawberry tart here. Okay. In honor of Dave, I had to go ahead and finish that up there. But, yeah, this busy day, good day. Anytime we get the head ball coach, it's always good. People are all a Twitter. Speaking of a Twitter, I guess Spurrier left here and immediately went to back to the airport and stopped at Arby's. There's a picture of him at Arby's on the way out of town for media days. But he had a big day today. I told somebody earlier, I'm going to be on with Paul Feinbaum at 6 o'clock tonight on the SEC Network. Talk about Steve. I told somebody, I said, when you have a transcript and you can get 3 stars on items, pretty good transcript. I have 8. And some of the things he said today wasn't even the best he's ever been here, but here's one you have to love. How's this for an answer when they ask him why he was still coaching as a head coach after 26 years? He said, well, I forgot to get fired and I'm not going to cheat.
I forgot to get fired and not going to cheat. Now, I was told to ask you today because I ran into Coach Ron Zook at Gateway Bank today. Coach Zook is in town in Ocala, and I said, I said, you were up at SEC Media Days. He said, well, ask him if the head ball coach is walking around with the swagger like he's really bragging on his football team, or is he a little subdued? Because that's the difference between a good team and a team with some work to be done. So how would you take the head ball coach today?
I don't know if swagger would be the right word. He's like he always was. He's full feisty. He has some good answers, but he did say things that you never heard him say before, like how much he appreciates the 7-6 record, and talking about teams like Texas A&M going 8-5, and was Auburn they go? He said 8-5 is not too bad in the SEC. And he says I'm gonna stick up to the SEC. People ask him about the SEC being down. He said we were 5-0 in our bowl games last year, and he said so. I'll tell you something else. Now this is only way. Spurrier is the only guy I know who can be a spin doctor without actually spinning. Here's what puzzles me, and that is that he said today he's the youngest coach in the SEC to ever win 4 straight bowl games. Okay, you with me?
Mm-hmm.
It'll be this. Okay, now you know how old he is, right?
Yes,
70.
Right.
He also happens to be the oldest coach ever coaching in the SEC. We looked it up today. Bear Bryant was 69 when he quit. So how could this be possible? He's the only coach to win 4 straight bowl games in the
SEC. Coach Spurrier at his best.
Yeah. I'm not going to take up the time, ladies and gentlemen. Dave, thanks for being there and your guest. Appreciate that very much. I just want to say thanks to our fine sponsors if I can. Of course, ATG Hotels, great people, the supporters of all things sports, high school sports in our county, and as well as CF Basketball, Randy Briggs, who's been very part of our program for a long time, the Briggs Law Firm, Randy and Bo, appreciate that, and our good friend Robert Hagee at Ocala Coffee Center. Thanks to all of them for helping us make this trip to up here possible. I'll talk to you again at 5:15 today, and at 6 o'clock, if you're around I guess it's on TV, but it's a radio show, Paul Feinbaum, I'll be on with Paul. The SEC Network at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, I've already DVR'd something else. So just so you know, I've already DVR'd something.
you've heard all my stuff anyway, Dave. Hope you're doing well. He's not abusing you, is he, Dave?
No, we're great. We're doing great.
All right, well, great, and thank you for coming in today and putting the show together. Thanks to your guests too. I'll get out of here. Let you guys talk food.
Thank you, buddy.
Have fun,
Buddy Martin, live from SEC Media Days. So you know, sounds like your burger probably have went over well up at SEC Media Days.
Oh, I think so.
You go up there and cook the Cuban burger for him up there.
Yeah, I can't imagine anywhere where it wouldn't work, you know.
Now, let me ask you, when you go, because you're going to go back, you're going to be one of the 2 finalists, okay? We're just going to go ahead and we're going to make that happen. Mm-hmm. By the way, how is this voting taking place to derive the 2 finalists?
Well, you got to get on, it's all social media, Facebook, so you get on the... Basically, if you've got Facebook, go up to the top and hit Live with Kelly and Michael Show. Live Kelly and Michael Show. It'll pop up and then go directly to their Facebook. View basically my 2 videos. You got to like them and then you got to share them.
So you got to like it and share it.
Yeah, you get points for viewing, liking, and sharing. You know, I was pretty pumped up because I've got somewhere around 84,000 views so far.
You got 1.8 million likes so far.
His video has 1.8 million
Holy
likes.
Holy cow.
Is that that many? Wow.
That's more than two or three.
Yeah, a lot of burgers.
To get this guy to come over on to the restaurant. We have to feature that hamburger one day or something, you know?
Wow. We're going to his house Saturday. I know where that house is, near the neighborhood that house is located in. I play a lot of golf in that general area.
I gotcha. I gotcha. But, you know, the timing of a sandwich like that, you know how I always talk about classics?
Yeah.
And comfort food. Come on, the timing. You know, it's hot. It's what I mean by hot is I mean it's you know, it's popular. People are learning about the Cuban sandwich, and to marry it with a classic like a burger with what it can only be a winner. It really can.
Well, Cuba and relations with America have been such in the news right now here lately.
Yeah.
With the opening back up of flights. I mean, last week in Orlando, all the news channels sent reporters on the first chartered flights to Cuba back to see what's going on. So it's really in the news, but it's a food that that's one of the reasons I love being from Florida, is the Cuban influence of food. I'm a huge fan. I got a friend of mine that they make a Cuban sandwich, and it's a big production where it's a piece of bread he bakes. It's like this long, and yeah, when I'm doing this, I'm showing you about a yard long, and he cuts it into slices and presses it and everything. And he invites everybody over, and it's like a gathering and a party for him to make this Cuban for everybody. And that says a lot about the Cuban culture. Is every time I've been around my friends that are of Cuban descent, it's never just a couple people over. It's a party when you're over there grilling out and having food. Oh, yeah. And that's what this burger sounds like. It would be a great addition to one of those parties.
And it's never subdued. The parties are never quiet.
Yeah, no, we're very loud. Yeah.
I think that may have something to do with the whole Latin thing, because Italians, we're very loud as well.
Exactly. Yeah, I had a buddy of mine going, I saw you on TV. Are you sure you're not Italian because you're moving your hands around a lot? I said, you know, we're a lot alike. So...
Now, so Facebook liked the video and shared the video. Two finalists go back to now. Are you going to make the same? Will you remake the same thing in New York?
No, I have no idea what happens when you get to that next step. I know that two go back. I don't know if you make the same thing or you have to come up with something else, you know. But we still got 30 days to figure that out if I'm one of the fortunate ones to be
But you
chosen.
Don't have 30 days to vote.
No, you've got till tomorrow at 4 o'clock to vote, you know. And
tomorrow 4 o'clock. Everybody get your votes in.
4 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah. Eastern. So yeah, you gotta Google that, you know, as far as Live with Kelly and Michael on and get on their Facebook, view it, share it. You get points for how many people viewed it, how many people shared it.
Luke, you know, and Luke, it. We're posting that on the Buddy Martin Voice of Ocala Facebook page right now, so we'll let everybody know out there. And you know, I think we ought to. I'm gonna post it on my page, and then I'm gonna put it on some groups that I'm a member of, because
cool.
I need
all the support.
I know a bunch of groups that, you know, word of mouth and all kind of places we can put that. So now, when we talk recipes, we've talked about this one, the Cuban burger, but sounds like to me, you got quite a Rolodex of them, but now are the recipes in the Rolodex of the mind, or do you have them written down somewhere?
No, it's all in my mind. I make my own barbecue sauce, and that really started off. And a lot of the stuff like this, I'm going to start making my own mojo. I've been buying it, but I decided now I'm going to make it. And the barbecue sauce turned into the same kind of thing. It was add a little bit of this. It's always got bourbon in it. It's always got brown sugar in it. You know, I make a chili that I use, instead of red beans, I use black beans. And all of the meats are smoked first. So, and it's got pork tenderloin. It's got beef tenderloin. My hamburger, I put it on the smoker and grind it up. My Italian sausage that goes in, it goes on the smoker. So when this chili comes out, it's hot, it's smoky. You know, it's just different things. I got, you know, I don't know. I've got ribs that I make a little bit different. You know, they're infused with a combination of mojo, and you know, so you get that my hot sweet barbecue sauce on top, kind of a crunchy top. You get in the middle of it, you got mojo. So you basically have a sweet and sour rib that's been smoked.
Dave, correct me if I'm wrong. I've been in restaurant business quite a while. You're a chef. There's a whole lot of complexity in everything he's talking about here. There's a lot of flavors going on.
You know what? And that's what makes it so good, because you're right. There's a lot of flavors going on. Just the flavors of mojo, you know, the onion, the garlic, the citrus, the, you know, all the different things that go into that. You know what I mean? Just that is an explosion of flavor. So, yeah, you know, I'm excited to try it. And
Saturday, Dave.
Saturday. I'm out of town this Saturday, but...
You know, that took him a long time to finally figure out how to quell Saturday, right?
But he got it in.
Hey, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap up the restaurant and food show. Find out what's going on at Eaton's Beach. It's summertime, so I'm sure there's a lot going on at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. More with Chef Dave Del Rio and Jose Juarez. Did I say that right?
You got it.
Got it right. A finalist for America's Next Grilling Star on Kelly and Michael. You're listening to it on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Your quality of life is meant to be fully enjoyed each day. The doctors at Ayers Global understand that and strive to provide a quality of life for you that has no equal. Ayers Therapeutic Services combines naturopathic and family medicine to help all your health needs. Diabetic management, hypertension, pain management, and anti-aging are just a few of the services offered by the Ayers family. Call 352-512-0222 today, and Ayers Therapeutic Services will help you begin to understand that better health begins with you.
Are you one of those golfers that use the .coms to try to find the best deal available every day of the week? Well, why use a middleman? For $100, you can be a summer member at Pine Oaks of Ocala. And what do you get with your Pine Oaks membership? Well, you get to play all the golf that you want in the afternoons, and all you do is pay the cart fee. $8 for 9 holes or $12 for 18 holes. This is the golf deal of the summer. Don't miss it. That's the $100 summer membership at Pine Oaks of Ocala.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWCE.com. Safe boating is no accident. Mostly clear for tonight, lows 71 to 73. For tomorrow, clouds and sunshine with a shower or thunderstorm, high 88 to 92. Tomorrow night, cloudy, low 71 to 75. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 89 to 91. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Andy Robb.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee. All for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit TurnerPest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
Are you in need of custom screen printing, embroidery, or promotional items? Then look no further and come visit the brand new Legacy Team Sales. LTS is conveniently located off 17th Street next to Armstrong Homes in beautiful Ocala. We offer the best prices and highest quality products for your company, team, school, or nonprofit. Whether looking for screen printed shirts, embroidered polos, or travel team uniforms, you'll be sure to find it at Legacy Team Sales. Come visit our new 27,000 square foot facility. Our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff
staff will assist you in every part of your custom purchase. LTS carries the hottest brands in the industry, like Under Armour, Russell, Mizuno, Asics, Badger Sports, Gildan, Pacific, OGO, and many more. At LTS, screen printing embroidery is done in-house, and we guarantee customer satisfaction. Stop by, give us a call, or check us out on the web at shoplts.com. Remember the name, LTS.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back as we wrap up the Restaurant and Food Show here on a Tuesday afternoon. The clouds are starting to roll in. That afternoon thunderstorm looked like it's building. Speaking of building, I just found the video with you with a blue-haired Kelly and Michael. And,
yeah, she looked great, didn't she?
You got quite the spread out there and everything. We've already shared it on the Buddy Martin Voice of Ocala Facebook page. So if you want to go out and help Jose Juarez out to become the next American Grill Master, American Grilling Star.
Grill Star, yes. Yeah,
Grilling Star. You go and like and share it, and you get enough. I'm looking at this now. The views on this page, I don't know how many likes and shares I hadn't got, it don't pan down, but the views are 35,576 that watched your 5 minutes.
Yeah, and then they have two videos, so if every time you look at each one, I think both of them combined were, you know, higher, 85,000, 84,000, something like that. But
so go out and help Jose bring the Grill Star Championship to Ocala.
Hey, you know what I just thought? Maybe he'll have me on his show.
There you go.
After he wins.
Dave, we got about 2 minutes. What's going on out at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill? We just got through with July 4th. I know that was a big success for you.
Yeah.
But what do we got? It's July. This weekend will be the 20th or something like that, the 5th, 19th, something like that.
Yeah.
What do you got coming up late in July and going into August?
Well, you know, where I'm working on some new stuff for downstairs. We still have our live music on Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, which is, you know, we've got some great acts there, and that's been really, really a lot of fun. You know, we're kind of business as usual for the moment. You know, we're waiting on what's the next one, Labor Day, and, you know, to come up, but we're building something special for that. But I'm working on some food, you know, so get
and
ready
call,
for that.
And call. Because you got jet skis now, too. So make
that's
sure
right.
you
make sure. Jet, and you know what? The jet skis, that's a lot of fun. That's really added a lot. You know what we've got on the beach now, too? We've got life-size Jenga. How cool is that?
Life-size Jenga.
Yeah, they're huge. They're like 2x4s, and it's so much fun to play that.
I got to come play that.
I'm telling you, it's a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite spots.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. Yeah. You know, we have a good time.
it is a fun. It's a fun time. I'm particular. I like the golf cart ride from the parking lot down and back up. But that's just
Mr. Ben.
Mr. Ben. I like. I'm just.
He's a great guy.
Jose Juarez, thanks so much for stopping by the show today.
Thanks
good
for having
luck,
me.
Good luck to you in the competition, Dave Del Rio. As always, thanks to Susan for bringing you. Because without Susan, you wouldn't be here.
That's right.
But
that's right.
Thanks for all you bring to the show. Make sure you get out to Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. See what they got going on out
Come
there.
See me.
Upstairs, downstairs, out on the beach. Always activity going out there during the summer. Also, check out Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood on the square in beautiful downtown Ocala for all your fine dining needs. Coming up next, Buddy Sports page. Buddy will check back in from SEC Media Days right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Do you experience body aches, joint, or a muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia,
RedStar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call RENSTAR Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's RENSTAR Medical Research, 352-629-5800. RENSTAR Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such is the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer. In everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
The next drink is on Dave Del Rio at Eaton's Pete's Sad Barn Grill. Just ask him for it. But don't wait. Show up soon because this offer isn't going to last very long. Eaton's Pete's Sand Bar and Grill will be filling up fast because their friends from the north are headed back that way soon. The good news is that seating is now available and Dave's buying the first drink. If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Pete's Sand Bar and Grill and couldn't get in, now you can see firsthand what your friends have been talking about. Great food. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Great location. Check out those gorgeous sunsets over Lake Weir. Great people. Starting with Chef Dave Del Rio, who began his career in 1978. This spicy guy has been instrumental in opening over 100 restaurants. And he's buying you a drink. Eaton's Pete's Sand Bar and Grill, where there's little or no waiting these days. Come see what started out as Jay Eaton's dream almost 90 years ago. It's more awesome than ever.
You can have work done on your vehicle anywhere, but why would you? Maybe they correctly determine the problem and suggest the proper service. There's a chance they won't. Eliminate that chance by bringing your vehicle to Ford Lincoln of Ocala or Village Ford of Bellevue. The professionally trained, factory-certified team understands the service requirements and maintenance needs of your vehicle, and when the unexpected repair comes your way, you can be assured the work will be done correctly, quickly, and cost-effectively. Look, you've invested a lot of your hard-earned money in your transportation to deliver performance, reliability, and safety. So doesn't it just make sense to trust the professional team at Ford Lincoln of Ocala and Village Ford of Bellevue to ensure you many miles of worry-free driving and peace of mind knowing the service was done correctly? So the choice is yours. Take the hard-earned investment to whoever for service or a factory-trained certified technician at Ford Lincoln of Ocala or Village Ford of Bellevue. To schedule your next completely satisfied service for your vehicle, contact those who know it best, Village Ford of Bellevue or Ford Lincoln of Ocala, your family of Ford dealerships where we've got what it takes.
On the next AM Ocala Live, a new show. It's called Food Truck Talks. We've got a lot of food trucks in Ocala, and wait till you hear about them. Jeremy Adams is coming in from Prestige Food Trucks. Mark Robert DiBenedetto is coming on. He's the president of Big Country Entertainment. And Scott Snyder will be on the air. He's from Papa Pineapple's Food Truck. Mmm, sounds good, Robin.
Yeah. News Bites, the hottest news and current events served bite-sized.
And then Laura Burns will be in the studio with us. She's from Career Source, Citrus Levy Mary, and she'll be letting us know about some job opportunities.
Charles D. Morgan is a race car driver. He's written a new book called Matters of Life and Data. It's his memoir.
And then attorney John Fuller from the law firm of Fuller & Fuller here in Ocala answering your legal questions on Legally Yours.
David Cohen is a law professor at Drexel University. He's written a book called Living in the Crosshairs.
And then the voice of travel, Anthony James, will be here from Homewood Suites by Hilton Ocala. All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
La Famiglia Pizzeria has moved into Ocala. Stop by today at 2504 Southeast 17th Street and see for yourself what everyone is talking about.
Awesome place. I never get pizza anywhere else.
Great New York-style pizza and dishes.
Best pizza in Ocala.
One trip and you'll agree, La Famiglia Pizzeria is the best. La Famiglia Pizzeria. Stop by for a pizza that you'll love or call in and order yours for pickup. 352-245-2419. La Famiglia Pizzeria.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Iran has gotten its nuke deal with the West. The Secretary of State tries to explain why he and the President are behind it.
We negotiated a restraint in their nuclear program because President Obama believes, and I share the belief, that if you're worried about Iran's behavior in the region, you are far better off preventing them from having a nuclear weapon than worrying about an Iran with a nuclear weapon.
John Kerry, the deal will now head to Congress, which has 60 days to review and possibly reject it. The president has pledged to veto any rejection.
Both houses of Congress will get a simple majority vote to approve or reject the nuclear agreement with Iran. Republican House Speaker John Boehner already calls it unacceptable. Some Democrats also might vote to reject the agreement.
Fox Radio, Steve Taylor. Stocks closed higher for the fourth day in a row. The Dow finished up 76, NASDAQ added 33, S&P rose 9. Fox News. We report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At Termbusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call Termbusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
How much time? 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho.
And now it's time for the Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't fit in. Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
Welcome back to hour number three of the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports Page. Tom Schmitz along with intern Luke and our special guest host for a few days while Buddy is out of town, Clint Lewis. Clint, did you watch, I got to ask right away, did you watch the Home Run Derby last night?
I watched a little bit of it. I watched Albert in the first round.
Flame out in the first round.
Yeah, but that was amazing what he did. Did you see?
Yeah.
He had his last two shots with no time or time ticking down, clutch, boom,
right, boom
to get
boom.
To the next round.
Right.
That was that's classic Albert back in the day.
What I liked about it is the format change this year. It's the first time that I'd seen this format, and I was not prepared. I didn't know the format had changed. I hadn't read anything about
it. You hadn't
the
read
format.
About that? I mean, it's really something that you would, you know, get out and research and
yeah, I didn't
the
read
rule
about
changes
it.
Of the
didn't,
All-Star
didn't
game.
Didn't read
home
about
run
it
derby.
Or anything. Yeah, it's amazing. I didn't do the required research on the home run. You know, I also didn't know in the Celebrity All-Star, Celebrity Softball game, that Snoop Dogg was going to play in the outfield. But last night I was surprised. Macklemore was playing second base. I did not know that was going to – I guess if I'd have done my job, I'd have researched right. that a little better. But – so the Home Run Derby changed last night. They had 5 minutes, but they shortened it to four because of the threat of rain, which never materialized. So it was 4 minutes where you didn't – before it was 10 outs, and so they would sit up there, and they would just take pitch after pitch after pitch, and it took forever to get this thing done. And, I mean, it was by the time you got to the final round, you were like, I'm so bored of this and everything. But last night they had a time limit. You can get as many swings, no outs. There wasn't before; it was 10 outs. Now there's no outs. You get as many swings as you can get in 4 minutes. But it really put an urgency on the batters, and everybody thought, well, you know, when I first thought, I said, oh, they're not going to hit as many home runs. You know, they hit twice as many home runs last night as they did the year last year.
Really?
In the old format. Twice as many home runs last night. And, I mean, they hit some home runs where people looked like the ball was on the inside part of the plate, jamming them, and they hit some home runs that way. So I was really impressed with the new format last night. One by Todd Frazier, hometown Cincy guy. You know, that's the first time that a player from the ballpark where the All-Star game was happening won the home run derby since 1990. Could you take a guess who that was?
No, Barry Bonds.
No. Nope. You're a big fan. 1990 on the north side of Chicago.
Oh,
Ryan
Sammy
Sandberg.
Sosa. Oh, Sandberg.
1990.
Oh, 90.
I know you're,
okay,
huge,
90, 90,
I know you're
yeah.
a huge Cubs fan. You know, you go to sleep in red and blue because you're a Cubs fan.
Right.
Yeah. By the way, for those who don't know, Clint Lewis is a staunch St. Louis Cardinal fan, and it is almost blasphemous for me to even say he would like the Chicago Cubs.
That's right. That's right.
It is the only baseball rivalry in major leagues that is like a football rivalry.
It is. They do not like each other. I like the format as well, and it brought another dimension for the pitchers. You know, now they've got to, hey, here comes a pitch. You can't waste any time.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Here comes another one. Yeah.
I thought it was something that made it fresh. And Luke and I have talked that one of the biggest things, you're a baseball fan. I know you're a baseball fan. I'm a baseball fan. Luke's 18 years old. Luke, would you classify yourself as a baseball fan?
No, probably the furthest from a baseball fan.
And you know, Clint, you and I are a dying breed. There's generations behind us that don't watch baseball.
Oh, absolutely.
Because it's boring to them. Mm-hmm. And it's not – they hadn't kept up like the NBA does, marketing its stars like the NFL does. Baseball's missed the boat on that. And I thought last night was a step towards figuring out that you got to do something to make it fresh and make it fun to watch. Last night – the home run derby. I thought I'd watch. I told Luke, I'll probably watch a few minutes of it. It'll be on in the background. I watched every minute of it. It was fascinating to me to see how they had to swing and how they had to. And I mean, it moved because of the time limit and all. They were able to do it in 2.5 hours. It didn't take 4 hours.
And how about the technology? The ball hits the stands, and immediately it's
they know the distance.
That's so cool.
The distance, the actual distance, and the projected distance. So that's some algorithms giving them that right away. And I like the format that if you hit the ball over 425 feet, you got extra time. That was so now. Not only are you hitting home runs, but if you hit bombs, you're getting extra time.
Yeah, that's.
And that was a fresh new thing.
Yeah.
And the way Albert Pujols, like you said, would time run. Down, you know, right there up against it.
He stepped out, took a deep breath.
And then hit two bombs.
Boom. Yeah.
It was really a good show last night. And, you know, I could care less about this celebrity softball game that came on afterwards. What's the girl, Jeannie? She was on the USA women's softball team. She was pitching. Raleigh
right.
Fingers was pitching, and you know you got to see rap stars and all playing softball, and it was nothing. That's like the NBA used to do that with they would partner with MTV and have the Rock and Jock basketball for the NBA weekend. That's baseball's problem. The NBA and MTV did that 20 years ago. That
right.
sums up what the problem with baseball is. While the home run derby was a good move. The celebrity softball game afterwards that ESPN showed afterwards, that's 20 years too late. You know, I tuned that right off, turned it right out. But I am going to watch the All-Star game a little bit tonight. Now, will you watch the game tonight, Clint?
Probably about the same as yesterday, as last night. I'll turn it on, and if I'm interested, I'll keep watching, but I'll probably flip it on.
What do you think maybe are some ideas that would get young kids to like the game of baseball? Because, and I always hear the complaint, it's terrible to watch on TV. To go to a game live is fantastic.
Right.
To go to baseball games live are great because it's always, the TV doesn't catch the essence of the movement of the game. It used to. I don't know what it either. It didn't used to, but it was. We only had one game a week on TV before cable, so that was what it was. I don't really know what it was about baseball, because you could watch baseball, and the games were faster back then. Games, you know, Greg Maddux used to pitch games that would last under 2 hours.
Yeah, the pitchers take way too much time stepping, and then the batter's stepping out of the box. They need to speed it up. That would help. But it really, doesn't it just come down to dads and families taking their kids to the ballpark when they're little, getting them interested in the game little? I mean, I think that's...
The game has become so expensive now.
It is.
When we played baseball, when I was a kid, I had all the equipment. I had like 9 gloves. I had 8 or 10 baseball bats, wooden and aluminum. I had bases built, and my dad took about a 4-acre piece of land right next to where the house was and created a baseball field for us. And all the kids would come over, but, you know, I bet with gloves, bats, and everything total, there was $150 worth of equipment.
Right.
A glove's $300. A bat's $500.
Yeah, bats are expensive.
You know, it's ridiculous.
But, you know, I think the other piece is that other sports have gained a lot of momentum in America. Soccer.
Yeah.
Whenever I grew up, we lived in a small town in Illinois, and we didn't play soccer. No one knew what soccer was. Everyone played baseball and football and basketball. No soccer.
And the specializing in sports, too, because like right. You said, we played baseball, football, and basketball.
Right. Yeah, in high school, I played every sport. And now when my daughter came through, she was really good at a couple sports. And they, you know, if you're going to think you're going to go somewhere with one of these, you better pick one.
Yeah.
See, and you got to do travel league.
See, I was a four-letter athlete in high school. Lettered in 4 separate sports in high school. Nobody does that anymore.
No.
Buddy Martin lettered in 4 sports. Yep. Nobody letters in 4 sports anymore. We're going to take a break. When we come back, Buddy Martin joins us right here on the Buddy Martin sports page. See, I almost claimed it as mine, the Saturday sports page. 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Are you looking for a durable farm fence to keep your horses enclosed, or a beautiful vinyl fence to give that finishing touch to your home? Seminole Fence has over 20 years of experience in providing quality fence products and services for farm and residential properties. Let them surround your property with a fence that provides privacy, security, and stunning appeal. Don't wait. Contact them today at 352-208-0959 for a free estimate. Seminole Fence, working hard to build fences and harder to build relationships.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Mostly clear for tonight, lows 71 to 73. For tomorrow, clouds and sunshine with a shower or thunderstorm, high 88. to 92. Tomorrow night, cloudy, low 71 to 75. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 89 to 91. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Andy Robb.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
Come join Newmail Medical for their town hall at Golden Corral in the Villages on Wedgwood Lane, Tuesday, July 21st and Wednesday, July 22nd from 4 to 6 p.m. Join renowned expert Dr. Christopher Asandra and get your questions answered. He will be discussing the importance of hormonal replacements and common misconceptions for men and women, as well as the importance of sexual health and anti-aging. Now, dinner and refreshments will be provided for those in attendance, along with door raffles and giveaways. But seating is limited, so please call today to reserve your space at the Golden Corral in the Villages on Wedgwood Lane. Call today, 404-4779. That's 404-4779. One more time, 404-4779. And make plans to join Newmail Medical.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to Buddy Sports Page. Let's go right out to the hotline, all the way to Hoover, Alabama. Join Buddy Martin. Buddy, getting set for the Paul Feinbaum show at 6 o'clock, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to talk to Paul about, obviously, Spurrier's press conference today and all things Stephen Orr Spurrier. He's filled it up once again. If you've seen the transcripts, there's probably six choice comments in there today. So we'll talk about that some. Feinbaum is big Spurrier fans, you know, too. So.
Buddy, I'm at BuddyMartinMedia.com, and I'm looking at the Martin Chronicles. And two things that I come across. The first one I want to talk to you about before we get to Jim McElwain, your column about Jim McElwain, is the remembering the Sky Riders. And you talk about how the SEC Media Days come a long, long way from 1966. What were the Sky Riders, and why is that memory so fresh for you?
Because it's the first time they ever did anything like that. I was a young buck in his early 20s. There were 35 or 36 riders around the southeast. We got in an old plane and flew around these SEC stops. And I don't know that maybe one of the group, two of the group maybe still working. Some of them are dead. Many of them are retired. And it was just quite a day to get that much football in, going pillar to post, two schools a day. And the interesting times, myself, my roommate was Neil Ender, later the New York Times sports editor, and we had quite a time just going in and out of port and getting in and out and getting coaches interviewed. So they got this thing refined now down to a science. And of course, this was Spurrier's 23rd media days, which tells you how long the ball coach has been around today. And he had some classic comments. I think I told you earlier. I asked someone to ask him why he could be a last this long after 26 years. He said, well, I forgot to get fired and I'm not going to cheat. one of his many good quotes he had today. So
well, I know it's very busy times up there. I actually caught you, by the way. I don't think you were aware of it, but you walked right they were doing a live ESPN broadcast, and they had a Paul Feinbaum and two other guys sitting in the chair right outside the entrance to the media room, and you walk right by through the camera, and I was like, well, he's actually there. He's not on some beach sipping Mai Tais and eating bonbons. He's actually working.
Yeah, I didn't know. I don't know where the cameras are over there. I couldn't tell you, but I was looking to check with his producer, John, to confirm that 6 o'clock at the time, so I guess it will be on the SEC Network, the audio part of it at least, on the Paul Feinbaum show. We'll see what that goes. Just a word about yesterday, and Jim McElwain wrote a column on Southern Michigan about today. As I said, he fought the media monster to a draw. He was probably was most proactive that Florida contingent has been in quite some time. Jim McElwain, who's gotten some criticism about some of his lethargic responses and answers, one of them one time being called a used car salesman by a friend of ours, actually came out yesterday with a smile on his face and had some good things to say and brought a little sunshine and optimism. I wouldn't say overly optimistic, but certainly cautiously optimistic. And actually made a comment that Will Muschamp and his staff did some really good things. That's the first I've heard of any props for the ex-Florida coach, because as you know,
it was quite a chilly relationship there.
Yes, it was.
Now, I noticed that you list in your, when you're writing your column, I read this, that he was asked about the head ball coach, Steve Spurrier, and I thought that was a very interesting comment he had about Steve Spurrier.
Yeah, I mean, I just put part of it in there. He talked about what it was like for him. He says that he talked about seeing the voicemail of Florida, too, and the Grays Memorial. And he said he has, so I have goosebumps right now thinking about it. He said that was his first experience. We didn't talk about it, but you know, that was a moment when Spurrier, sitting close by, called him over and said, "Come on, Jim, let's teach you how to do this." And he swayed to and fro, saying, "We're the boys." And he said that was quite a moment for him. Yeah, he said every day when I go to work, he said, "I pass the statue." He said, "That's pretty cool. There's a Heisman Trophy winner right there." He said, "I look forward to somebody that'll sit down and pick his brain, because he's one of the true guys that knows how to get it done." So respect there from the Gator, new Gator coach.
So, buddy, if you had to give him a grade, I know you said he fought to a draw, but if you had to give him a grade on the first day, as you know, it's official now, he's went through spring practice and all, but his first day as the Florida head coach was his first day at SEC Media Days for the 2015 season. If you had to give him a grade, where would Buddy Martin give Jim McElwain a grade right now?
I'd give a solid B, just because of his efforts and the fact that he did. Of course, everybody has to work the rooms, so when you think adding up all the things they got to do, and I'm sure it was overwhelming to him because he's never been through one of these before like this. And I think he did fine. I don't think he revealed anything terribly, terribly important. He didn't tell us who the starting quarterback is going to be. He didn't say much more about his offensive line. He just put a little spin on it. So, I think I'd give him a B. I was asked a while ago by our friends from Southern Pigskin, by the way, what about who had the most spin so far on anything? And, you know, we talked about various people who – I said, well, McElwain kind of spun it a little bit because he actually said something complimentary about his offensive lineman. We all know that's an issue for him. And then I said, here's the thing about Steve Spurrier. He is the least guy in the world to spin anything because he's so direct and he's so straightforward and honest, and he never goes off the record with people. But he has his own little ways. For instance, I think I told you this last hour. He asked us, he said, I'm the youngest coach to ever have won four straight bowl games in the SEC. Now, ironically, that's, quite unusual, since Steve happens to be at 70, the oldest person to ever coach in the SEC. But he's also the only coach in the SEC to win four straight bowl games. So that's a little spin right there by Steve. But, and, of course, the cameras caught him on his way out of town. Guess where he stopped? Arby's. He seems to stop at Arby's, same Arby's, every year on the way out of town. Give himself a sandwich and head back to the plane and go to Columbia. So, that's same old Spurrier. Every time I've been eating with him in Columbia, he's always eating he wants to get like a turkey sub or a turkey sandwich. He gets the same thing. Big sandwich guy. Anyway, Steve leaving town, have in a blaze of glory with an Arby's.
Well, buddy, we got about 3 minutes before we got to go to break here. Now, a coach that was also there today, I don't know if you got to hear much of what he said, but 8-5 last year at Texas A&M. People are saying Kevin Sumlin is squarely on the hot seat. Did that come across today? Was there an urgency there today?
Not really. I heard him talk a little bit about it, and John Chavis, and fact that he's got LSU defensive coordinator and how the coordinators move around and it's kind of the thing that they do. You know, Jeff Collins from Florida, it was at Mississippi State. It's what they seem to do. And he didn't have too much to say. He says quarterback Kyle Allen, after winning the bowl game, he got the MVP trophy. He said he walked around like it was a Stanley Cup, showing everybody. But he didn't see, he's a pretty cool customer. He didn't seem to be any panic set in. He's got a long contract of $5 million a year or whatever. So he's not likely to be they aren't likely going to buy him off anytime soon. So I'd say he did win eight. And by the way, Spurrier pointed out that he feels differently about 7-6 than he used to, and certainly 8-5. And he said we can't all win. So when you get an 8-5 record, you go to a bowl game. And even if you get a winning record, go to a bowl game, that's not so bad. So his standards have changed a little bit in that regard. That's what coaching in South Carolina and places like that will do for you, because you're not at Florida. You're not going to be able to win the national championship, most likely. And so you have to settle a little bit less. I think it's more like not maybe a half a loaf, but 3/4 of a loaf.
Buddy Martin from SEC Media Days. Buddy, I know that you wouldn't be able to be at SEC Media Days without the help of some great sponsors.
Appreciate it very much. I do appreciate them. Thanks to HDG Hotels, our friends over there who support high school sports as well, and CF basketball. Also to the Briggs Law Firm, Randy and Bo, in the historic district on Fort King. And also our friends, Bill Hagee down at Ocala Coffee Center. Thank you guys for making this possible.
Well, buddy, good luck tonight on the endeavors. I'm sure you got some more writing to do because you're right in the middle of doing all that as well. So we'll talk to you again tomorrow, and then I guess Luke will be picking you up from the Luke, the all-world intern, will be picking you up from the airport tomorrow night.
Yeah, I hope tomorrow night. I sure hope so. By the way, can I just say an RIP to my father-in-law, Mickey Sharp, who passed away yesterday.
I heard that.
Stepdad, yeah. And she's obviously very sad about it, but Mickey was 91, had a great life. I mean, a lot of people laugh, and like he always used to tell me, when I get to heaven, I'm going to make God laugh. So I guess maybe he's making him laugh today.
Buddy Martin, live from Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days. Thanks so much, buddy.
Talk to you tomorrow, Tom. Thanks.
Coming up next, I ran across this story, and it's about time. I'll tell you about that. It concerns the NFL and DirecTV. I'll tell you about that story next, right here, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local, The Source.
People make all kinds of mistakes with life insurance, like having some coverage but not enough to keep your family in the house, or only having life insurance through work and then losing your job. Want to avoid those mistakes? Get an Allstate agent. They can help you get the coverage your family needs at an affordable price. Are you in good hands?
Hey, this is Kevin McDonald. Make your family your priority. Let's get together and review your life insurance today.
Life insurance offered by Allstate Life Insurance Company, Northbrook, Illinois, and Lincoln Benefit Life Company, Lincoln, Nebraska.
Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself? Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke for everybody's enjoyment. If you would like to get in touch with KT Entertainment and find out about our competitive prices, call us at 352-512-2611. That's 352-512-2611. Or you can find us on the web at kt4fun.com. That's KT, the number 4, fun.com. So remember, whether it's a wedding reception, a party, or a company outing, it's KT Entertainment for all your karaoke, trivia, or musical needs.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige, it's all there in our name.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. Iran has gotten its nuke deal with the West. The Secretary of State tries to explain why he and the President are behind it.
We negotiated a restraint in their nuclear program because President Obama believes, and I share the belief, that if you're worried about Iran's behavior in the region, you are far better off preventing them from having a nuclear weapon than worrying about an Iran with a nuclear weapon.
John Kerry, the deal will now head to Congress, which has 60 days to review and possibly reject it. The president has pledged to veto any rejection.
Both houses of Congress will get a simple majority vote to approve or reject the nuclear agreement with Iran. Republican House Speaker John Boehner already calls it unacceptable. Some Democrats also might vote to reject the agreement.
Fox Radio, Steve Taylor. Stocks closed higher for the fourth day in a row. The Dow finished up 76, NASDAQ added 33, S&P rose 9. Fox News. We report, you decide.
Are you paying too much for term life insurance? There's a tremendous price war among the major term life companies, and rates have dropped dramatically in the past few years. For example, for a man age 45, non-tobacco user, it's $1 million of coverage and $75 per month level rate for the next 10 years. Or a man age 50, non-tobacco user, can obtain $500,000 of coverage for a monthly premium of only $110 per month, guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. That's right, level rate guaranteed not to change for the next 20 years. If you're a smoker, we have great rates available for you as well. At TermBusters, we specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. If you're looking for new or replacement term life insurance, call today for a quote at 1-800-862-8376. That's 1-800-862-8376. You're probably paying more than you should. Call TermBusters at 1-800-862-8376 or visit our website at termbusters.net. Remember, 1-800-862-8376. Rates and availability may vary by state. Sample rate quotes based on preferred non-tobacco underwriting. Exam required to qualify.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
On the next AM Ocala Live, a new show is called Food Truck Talks. We've got a lot of food trucks in Ocala, and wait till you hear about them. Jeremy Adams is coming in from Prestige Food Trucks. Mark Robert DiBenedetto is coming on. He's the president of Big Country Entertainment. And Scott Snyder will be on the air. He's from Papa Pineapple's Food Truck. Mmm, sounds good, Robin.
Yeah. News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Laura Burns will be in the studio with us. She's from Career Source, Citrus Levy Mary, and she'll be letting us know about some job opportunities.
Charles D. Morgan is a race car driver. He's written a new book called Matters of Life and Data. It's his memoir.
And then attorney John Fuller from the law firm of Fuller & Fuller here in Ocala, answering your legal questions on Legally Yours.
David Cohen is a law professor at Drexel University. He's written a book called Living in the Crosshairs.
And then the voice of travel, Anthony James, will be here from Homewood Suites by Hilton Ocala. All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need
too.
My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to Buddy Sports Page. I'm Tom Schmitz, along with Luke the intern. Just talked with Buddy up at SEC Media Days. He said Coach Spurrier was gold. And I didn't know the thing about Coach Spurrier. I like to spin. I'm the youngest coach to ever win four straight bowl games in SEC history. Because at 70, he's the only coach to win four straight bowl games in SEC history. You know, he's been at South Carolina now over double-digit years, just like he was at Florida. That's pretty good to take two different programs to bowl games like he's done and winning records like he's done. So Coach Spurrier, definitely an innovator. I ran across this. This is from the Hollywood Reporter. I ran by this, and I thought this was going to happen. I just didn't know when. A lot sooner, probably. It's happened a lot later than I thought it probably should have. But I have DirecTV now, so it doesn't bother me as much anymore. When I had Dish, this used to aggravate me. Well, now on Monday, a major class action lawsuit was filed against the National Football League and DirecTV by prominent antitrust attorney Michael Hausfeld and colleagues at Hausfeld's law offices. Hausfeld, who ESPN has called one of the most powerful people in sports, seeks to represent a class of commercial subscribers to DirecTV's Sunday Ticket, a package of all out-of-market football games led by a San Francisco pub. The plaintiffs will be bars and restaurants throughout the nation led by a San Francisco pub known as the Mucky Duck, seeking to what they end to see as a conspiracy. If bars and restaurants want to show their games, they must go through DirecTV, which has a $12 billion deal with the NFL. According to the lawsuit, a bar with an occupancy of 100 patrons will pay $2,314 in 2015 for the Sunday Ticket, while larger establishments like Las Vegas are charged more than $120,000 for the ticket. But the NFL team agreement with DirecTV has joined teams would compete against each other in the market for NFL football programming, which would likely induce more competitive pricing. Last month, lawyers representing football fans filed their own class action suit over Sunday Ticket, seeking an end to a system of blackouts and all-or-nothing out-of-market TV packages. The NFL and DirecTV were hit with these lawsuits after fans experienced some pretrial success in similar litigations against other sports leagues. All of this is, DirecTV has entered into an agreement with the NFL that they can sell the Sunday Ticket and nobody else can. And other cable subscribers and satellite services are saying that's a monopoly infringement. That's an antitrust infringement because it creates a monopoly. Like, you can get the NBA ticket. The NBA, what is it? The NBA season's pass, that's what they call it. You can get that by, you can get that on DirecTV. You can get that on Comcast. You can get that on Bright House. You can get it on Dish Network. What's the other one? Cox is in town here. You can get the league pass on all of those. You can only get the NFL Sunday Ticket if you have DirecTV. That's it. You can get Major League Baseball Extra Innings, which is the baseball package. You can get that on all the subscribers. I've said for a long time the NFL was really how somebody hadn't sued the NFL over what I thought was an antitrust infringement over only offering the NFL Sunday Ticket to DirecTV. I've always thought it was a violation, and I always thought, why hasn't a lawyer sued them yet? Now it looks like not only are lawyers suing them for fans, but they're suing them for bars as well, like we were talking about yesterday with the library system. Bars have to pay an exorbitant amount of money to show these kind of sporting events. And now the bars are saying enough. Think about that. A bar has to pay over $1,000 for the season. I pay $150. That's with 100 seats. You got 200 seats, you're paying over. It's by seats. You got 200 seats, you're going to pay almost $2,500 for football. And I know the NFL says, yeah, but the business it brings in. Oh, okay. I agree that it brings business in. But the NFL's making way. If they offered it, it would be competitive pricing where if they could do it with DirecTV or something. And think about that. The NFL could enter into an agreements where they made DirecTV pay them, Dish Network pay them, Cox pay them. They could all get a piece of the pie. It would be smaller pieces of pie. When you add it up, I bet the NFL would still make the same amount of money. And it opens it up to everybody in every market. I mean, would you be, Luke, and you get to watch Orlando because they're the local market. But let's say you were a New York Knicks fan. which you still would want to watch it. It's easier for you. I don't know what cable service you have at your house, but
DirecTV.
Well, DirecTV, so you're good too, like I am. You can get the Sunday ticket.
Right.
But if you had Cox, you could still buy basketball. Mm-hmm. Imagine if they only allowed the NBA only on DirecTV.
Yeah, I know it's all about money, and unfortunately that's what we've come to, is that everybody's just, the rich get richer, and I wish there was an agreement that was able to work out for NFL fans, for avid NFL watchers, to where DirecTV didn't take all the viewers and generated that as much money, like they need more. The NFL needs more, or DirecTV needs more, because they don't. But I guess being considerate takes a back seat to getting a lot of money, even though you already have a lot as it is. But you know, it's sad. It's sad that it's really come to that for the NFL.
You know, they're being sued under two separate violations, two sections of the Sherman Antitrust Act. And these aren't just some fly-by-night lawyers. These are the same lawyers that represented Ed O'Bannon and the college basketball and football players and all in their antitrust, in their lawsuits against looking for compensation for their images and all that are being done by EA Sports and everything, and just won that. AT&T is trying to merge with DirecTV, and just imagine how monopoly that will come. If you let AT&T and DirecTV go, and then the only thing they got to do, they can only sell the NFL to those two. I just think it's a clear, clear monopoly. And the Sherman Antitrust Act has outlawed monopolies. You know, Bell Telephone get broke up. It just makes no sense to me that the NFL is the only place that has an agreement that the NFL teams have with each other, and with the limiting of the Sunday football ticket to only DirecTV subscribers. It's almost like the NFL must own part of DirecTV, because they're making money that way. It's the only of the four major professional sports in the country. It's the only one with an exclusive out-of-marketing broadcast arrangement. And I just think, and I have DirecTV now, so it's not a problem for me, but I have friends who have Dish. I have friends who have Cox and everything. They would like to be able to, but what they have to do? And this is what they have to do. I got good friends of mine that are Green Bay fans. They have to go to a local bar somewhere or an eating establishment to watch a Green Bay game. Well, when you're there, you walk in, you spend, the average ticket for a football game with your drinks and food and everything is about $30, $31 a person, okay? About $30, $31 a person. You got to do that 16 weeks a year. Now, do that math. That's you're spending well over almost $600 just in what per person. You got a family, it's you, your son, and your wife that want to go, to three of you. Now you're looking at about $1,800 you're spending to go watch the Green Bay. Well, you don't have to go watch them. You don't have to eat when you're there. Okay, we know people go in and just order a glass of water and sit around. But the NFL is, I don't know, it just seems horrible, horrible business practice to me to exclude all the other providers, Luke. Am I wrong?
No, you're not. And one thing I was thinking about, the bars and stuff like that, and I could be completely wrong about this, but do all the bars, do they all have a certain way that they stream, do they all have different providers for streaming those games, the NFL games? Do they all?
Oh, that's the thing. Even if they have like Cox Cable and everything, if they want to stream the games, the football games, they have to get DirecTV as well.
Right, that's what I'm saying. Everybody's got to buy DirecTV.
Which is why almost every restaurant sports bar in the world is DirecTV, not anything else.
Right.
Because of the Sunday ticket.
Mm-hmm.
And see, it's just, think about that. They're forcing the market into only choosing one thing. You don't have a choice.
And do you think they care?
But it's against the law. The Sherman Antitrust Act was created to stop this kind of thing from happening. And the Shield, the NFL, just believes it can do whatever it wants and that it's above the law. That's the message here, is the NFL thinks, whatever, we're the NFL.
Well, that's the case with every sport, too, and that's another sad unfortunate thing is that every sports industry thinks that they run the show and laws don't apply to them, whether they're the players or the industry as a whole. And I think that's what we're seeing exercised with the NFL.
Well, the other sports leagues don't have the monopoly like the NFL does. The NBA, the Major League Baseball, and all, they don't. It's almost like the NFL says, here it is. We know it's the best sport out there, and either buy it or shut up because somebody's going to buy it. Mm-hmm. And I just don't like that kind of attitude. It infuriates me. But with that being said, I have DirecTV now just because I could get the Sunday ticket, because I got tired of having to go spend $30 or $40 a Sunday to go watch the Atlanta Falcons when I can spend $150, $200 for a season where I can watch all 16 Falcon games. And, oh, by the way, then I can watch whatever other game I want to watch besides the Falcons game. So, yes, I understand I have DirecTV, but I switched over from Dish to DirecTV. I really enjoy Dish more than DirecTV. The only reason I have DirecTV is the NFL Sunday ticket. It's the only reason. We're going to take a break. Come back. We'll wrap up this edition of the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports Page, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Do you experience body aches, joint or muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research, 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Are you one of those golfers that use the dot-coms to try to find the best deal available every day of the week? Well, why use a middleman? For $100, you can be a summer member at Pine Oaks of Ocala. And what do you get with your Pine Oaks membership? Well, you get to play all the golf that you want in the afternoons, and all you do is pay the cart fee. $8 for 9 holes or $12 for 18 holes. This is the golf deal of the summer. Don't miss it. That's the $100 summer membership at Pine Oaks of Ocala.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Mostly clear for tonight, lows 71 to 73. For tomorrow, clouds and sunshine with a shower or thunderstorm, high 88 to 92. Tomorrow night, cloudy, low 71 to 75. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 89 to 91. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Andy Robb.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
Come join New Mail Medical for their town hall at Golden Corral in the Villages on Wedgwood Lane, Tuesday, July 21st and Wednesday, July 22nd from 4 to 6 p.m. Join renowned expert Dr. Christopher Asandra and get your questions answered. He will be discussing the importance of hormonal replacements and common misconceptions for men and women, as well as the importance of sexual health and anti-aging. Now, dinner and refreshments will be provided for those in attendance, along with door raffles and giveaways. But seating is limited, so please call today to reserve your space at the Golden Corral in the Villages on Wedgwood Lane. Call today, 404-4779. That's 404-4779. One more time, 404-4779. And make plans to join New Mail Medical.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports page. Luke, I'm going to try to implore you. You know, I can't talk you into it, but are you going to at least try to give me one inning of the All-Star game tonight? You're going to try to watch at least one. I know you got softball tonight. Luke, the big softball, church league softball star that you are. Park can't hold you. You've said numerous times that if it wasn't for what's the other guy on your team that hits the home runs?
Sean.
Yeah, so you purposely don't hit home runs just right. So Sean can hit his.
I try to let him have his, yeah.
I understand. So you'll be playing softball, but afterwards, are you going to try to get at least one inning in the All-Star game?
You know, I try to watch some All-Star games every now and then. Every time there's an All-Star weekend or anything like that, I do try to watch a little. So I can't promise you I'll give you an inning, but I will. I'll attempt.
You'll make an effort.
I'll make an effort, yeah.
So, I was watching Dave Pingelor, Local 6, who's a contributor on this show quite a bit. I was watching him last night, and he was talking about the fact that, and this is one of the things, this is another reason why soccer confuses me. The Orlando City Lions, the Orlando Football Club, they're going to play a friendly Wednesday night, tomorrow night, against a club from England in the English Premier League. I forget Wharton or something. I forget the team name they're playing. But they're playing against a friendly against an English team out of the English Premier League. Doesn't count towards their season. They do have an MLS game that counts on Saturday at home. But they're going to play a friendly Wednesday night, and that confuses me. They're in the middle of a season. Why would you, in the middle of a season, play a team from outside? That would be like, you know, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers got a football game against the Green Bay Packers on Sunday, but hey, we're playing the Ottawa Rough Riders out of the Canadian Football League on Wednesday night. It doesn't really count, but we're going to play the Ottawa Rough Riders in football on Wednesday night, and then we're going to go play our regular scheduled game on Sunday. Who they're playing?
I believe it's West Bromwich.
Yeah, West Brom. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I don't understand that mentality of playing a friendly in the middle of your season that doesn't count towards anything from a team from another league.
I think that risks injury, doesn't it?
It does.
It risks injury. I mean, I don't know that I've kept track with friendly games and stuff like that. But in a friendly game, I'm wondering if they play their stars in friendlies.
Oh yeah.
And they play like a regular MLS game.
It's just like a regular MLS game.
That doesn't make sense to me.
It makes no, like I said, it's like the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are playing Green Bay on Sunday. We're going to play the Ottawa Rough Riders out of the Canadian Football League on Wednesday, just to stay sharp.
Yeah.
Hey, I'd like to thank my guest today, Jose Juarez. He is trying to be the next grill star on the Live with Regis and Kelly. I'm at Regis and Kelly. Look at there. Live with Kelly and Michael. See, I knew I'd mess that up before Dave was over. Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill from the Restaurant and Food Show. Also, Susan Del Rio for being here. I'd like to thank Clint Lewis for stopping by and helping out with the show. And, of course, Buddy Martin, live from SEC Media Days up in Hoover, Alabama. Thanks to him for checking in as well. For Luke the intern, I am Tom Schmitz, off to do trivia at Murphy's, at the Murphy's 2 location on Highway 27, just west of I-75. Come see me for trivia tonight at Murphy's. Have a great night, everybody.